on the agenda for Bilderberg 2015 and about his new documentary that's coming out. He'll be joining us for 30 minutes, start of the next hour. Then, always informative, we're going to be joined by one of the top preparedness global trends experts out there. Joel Skousen will be joining us to look at different global and domestic developments as well. So please stay with us today. This is a broadcast you're not going to want to miss. Quite frankly, you don't want to miss any of the broadcasts, but this one particularly is going to be jam-packed, and I'm wound up because obviously, you know, I missed some days last week. Here's what's coming up. Coldest months on record, February 2015, could be among the top five ever in the United States. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. And this is from mainstream news, CBS. So, but it doesn't matter. The new National Geographic's coming out, and it talks about the war on science. And on the cover, we have the cover tweeted out at Real Alex Jones. It says that climate change is not real. See, notice it's gone from global freezing to global warming being man-made, anthropogenic, to now we're just denying that climate ever changes. No, we've said the climate always changes, and the only constant is change. So notice their bait and switch. The war on science, climate change, does not exist. Vaccinations can lead to autism. We have the CDC's own top scientist as a whistleblower saying they were ordered to cover it up. Genetically modified food is evil. No, we just said that a lot of it, you know, that kills the bugs that eat it, also hurts humans' livers. I mean, they've had to recall Starlink corn and scores of other GMO crops that end up killing the farm animals that eat it. But see, they count on you being ignorant. Oh, my gosh, there's no problem with GMO. Oh, my gosh, these people don't believe that climate changes. No, we said anthropogenic global warming is a hoax, and it's been proven to be one. But that's, see, I just read one headline out of no exaggeration. I've probably got, listen, 200 articles in front of me. This is just one stack. Look at this headline. Texas governor, since January 1st, we've had more than 20,000 people come across the border illegally. That's the new Texas governor, Greg Abbott, told CBS's Face the Nation. Continuing, there's no economic and political freedom without economic freedom. Again, there's no political freedom without economic freedom. Economic freedom is the foundation of all freedom. That's Patrick Barron, von Mises Institute, up on Infowars.com. And that dovetails with this stack of news I'm going to get to. Federal Reserve insider Alan Greenspan warns there will be a, quote, significant market event. Something big is going to happen. And what is that something big? Again, CBS News. 4 of 10 Americans are one bill from disaster. How are we such a great economy when that's the case? ABC News survey finds many Americans on the edge of financial disaster, but the controlled media, at least the politicians most of the time, say that the economy's never been better. But then separately, more and more even establishment types are on television and in print saying, yes, get ready for major economic collapse, and the globalists are pre-positioning themselves right now. Meanwhile, CARE praises DHS report that came out last week during the terror summit, the extremist summit that extremist Muslims were not mentioned at. You cannot make that up. And said that right-wing extremists are the number one threat. We're going to be breaking that down. The Council on American-Islamic Relations has come out and praised the report, warning of libertarians, right-wingers, Christians, gun owner groups and veteran groups. They agree that's the main threat. This is like a satire novel or something. I mean, if I wrote a comedy novel about what's really going on, people buy it and laugh at it. But then they go, wait a minute, this is really going on. So that then dovetails with this stack of news. And remember the Kenya mall shooting of a few years ago that killed 60-plus people, what, 69 people, and wounded a whole bunch of others. That was carried out by Boko Haram, which is a Al-Qaeda-affiliated group. And, of course, that then expands down all the way into the middle of Africa, into the west of Africa, in Nigeria, not just Kenya. Well, when I first saw the threats coming out of this Al-Qaeda-ISIS group to attack Mall of America and other major malls, I pointed out yesterday, funny they said Mall of America, because if you go to Minneapolis, St. Paul, and I've been to many times because GCN Radio Network is based there, it's based in between Minneapolis and St. Paul, those two twin cities, almost everybody at restaurants serving you, driving the taxi cabs, at the hotels are Somali. And there's a government program to bring in Somalis from Somalia as, quote, refugees. And they're constantly getting caught, it's a minority of them, obviously, but cooking stuff up. But don't worry, there'll be no mention that unlimited illegal and legal immigration could cause a problem, even though ISIS is saying they're going to immigrate Europe and the U.S. with sleeper cells, because when they strike, they'll just have a summit and blame the Tea Party, like Obama did last week, and the Council on American-Islamic Relations will come out and praise it. They're not coming out and saying, hey, don't blame libertarians, don't use anti-terror laws to go after the American people. Just like we've said, don't use these laws to persecute Muslims. No. They're saying, good job. Get them. That's the bad guy. Right there. Alex Jones. Ron Paul. A video purporting, this is AP, to be by Somali Al-Qaeda-linked rebel group, Al-Shabaab, urged Muslims to attack shopping malls in the United States, Canada, Britain, and other Western countries. U.S. authorities said there was no credible evidence suggesting a U.S. mall was in the works, even though they said so. The threat by the Al-Qaeda affiliate came in the final minutes of more than hour-long video released Saturday in which the extremists also warned Kenya of more attacks like the September 2013 assault on the Westgate Mall in Nairobi in which 67 out of 69 people were killed. So this is Somali terror group that has attacked malls is saying, and of course the same link group attacked the mall there in India. And it turned out the government knew about that, and the head of the Indian anti-terror force tried to stop him, and he was killed hours before the attack was launched, probably by an inside job. So this is what's being hyped up. This is what's being prepared. And don't worry, when it happens, or when jet airliners get shot down by Stinger missiles given to Al-Qaeda and ISIS by our criminal government, Obama will have a summit. And they will blame veterans and gun owners and libertarians and Christians that have the lowest crime rate of any group in the United States. Again, they had their two-day meeting last week and came out and said the main threat is basically white people. If you slip on a banana peel, white people did it. And again, this is all part of just the divide and conquer strategy. And then they're turning the Middle East over to these radicals who then run around and kill non-radical Muslims. So there you go. Somali extremists urge attacks on U.S. shopping malls. And Minneapolis, St. Paul is loaded with recent immigrants from Somalia. Loaded. This is part of our government immigration program. Threat of attack draws shrugs at North American malls. Reuters. Kenyan president, Nairobi siege, makes comments on the malls. So that's just some of the news I've got on this front here. But I wanted to get into this article, The Terrifying Rise of ISIS. Map shows how terror groups' tentacles now reach from Algeria to Afghanistan. And if you're watching at Infowars.com/show or PrisonPlanet.tv, you can see this or just go to the Daily Mail article. They have an excellent map that shows them out of their Iraqi base given to them by the globalist, by NATO 5 years ago, then launching attacks into Syria, Jordan, and Egypt, as well as the West Bank. They're now attacking, again, Libya. They've taken the entire coastal area, as well as Tripoli. And, of course, who cares about the rest? It's all just desert. And now the same groups are spilling into Kenya and as far south and west as Nigeria. And as far east as Afghanistan. And it's all been resettled, re-upped, resupplied by the West on record as the Free Syrian Army. And they've now taken large swaths of Syria and Iraq as their new homeland. And then it says major ISIS stronghold is a black flag. areas in black are the roads and towns they fully control. And, of course, that's the oil fields and oil pipelines as well. And there's no investigation of who's buying the oil from them. I mean, the government, the federal government says that if you give money to a charity that then gives money to some affiliated group, you can get life in prison even if you didn't know. But then meanwhile, the big oil companies are allowed to just sit there with their big ships at the Suez Canal and other areas, the Strait of Hormuz, and load up on this oil that's coming out of those pipelines. This is so obviously the West and Saudi Arabia giving a funding mechanism to ISIS, who then launders the money they make back into Western banks. So there you go. And then when the terrorists attack, they can take our freedoms. The government can grandstand, and that's mission complete. That's how full spectrum dominance works. You control the enemy, you control the response, and you control the people you're supposedly protecting. All this and more, the rest of the story, straight ahead. James O'Keefe says he's afraid for his life with his biggest story ever.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Hey there, Guns80.com continues to surprise us with low prices and high-quality Ghost AR-15 rifle kits. At Guns80.com, Ghost AR-15 kits are an even better idea than buying at gun shows or through private parties, because the Ghost AR-15 kits at Guns80.com require no background checks, no registration, they don't even have serial numbers. That's what I call privacy. Go to Guns80.com to order your Ghost AR-15 rifle kit. No dealers, no hassles, ship direct. Guns80.com or 844-2-GUNS80. That's 844-248-6780.
As the new world order continues to tighten its grip on every facet of our lives, we're all asking ourselves, how can we maintain our independence? The answer is clear. Get prepared, and you get prepared now. Now the only question left is, where do we begin? My Patriot Supply is here to help. Call 800-247-3070 to get started with your 72-hour emergency food supply for only $10. We're even covering the cost of shipping. Are you willing to rely on the government and FEMA in the event of an emergency? Call 800-274-3070 to get started with your 72-hour emergency food supply for only $10. You won't be able to find this deal online, and there is a strict limit of 4 per caller, so don't wait. Call now, 800-274-3070. That's 800-274-3070. Call right now.
The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we, the Patriots, hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
Hey, sorry I'm running late. I had to stop and get my vitamins for the month.
I got mine in the mail yesterday from DiscountNutritionShop.com, so I'm here totally on time.
DiscountNutritionShop.com?
Yep, they're a lifesaver in more ways than one. They have all the nutritional supplements you need, the major brands you know. Plus, you can save up to 10%. Write down this number, 888-908-4548.
Huh?
888-908-4548. Or just go to DiscountNutritionShop.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
He said that the era of quantitative easing and zero interest rate policies by the Fed, that we really cannot exit this without some significant market event. And by that, I interpret it being either a stock market crash or a prolonged recession, which would then engender another round of monetary reflation by the Fed. So he thinks something big is going to happen, that we cannot get out of this era of money printing without some repercussions, and pretty severe ones, that gold will benefit from.
We're told the economy is so great, and again, Alan Greenspan has reportedly said a significant market event, something big is going to happen. And then meanwhile, CBS News reports 4 of 10, or 4 out of 10 Americans, are one bill from disaster. Almost 4 out of 10 Americans are living on the edge of financial ruin, given rainy day funds that either match or are lower than their credit card debt. About 24% have more credit card debt than emergency savings, while another 13% have neither credit card debt nor emergency savings. A new survey from Bankrate.com found, while Americans have never been particularly great savers, that's not true, at least in recent decades, many workers are finding it harder than ever to sock away money for emergencies. That's because wages have been stagnant or falling for most. The country's lowest paid workers are the only segment to see significant pay gain last year, thanks to minimum wage hikes. But because of inflation, that means nothing. People don't have enough money for unplanned expenses, and if they have more credit card debt than emergency savings, it's a double whammy, said Bankrate chief financial analyst Greg McBride. In the event of unplanned expenses, their options are limited. People between the ages of 30 and 49 are in the worst shape. They're supposed to be your top spenders, is between 30 and 49, by the way, folks. That's the part of your life where you spend the most, which is likely due to financial stresses of that age group, such as saving or paying for their children's tuition and paying for higher expenses such as mortgages and child care. Nevertheless, more Americans are in better shape this year than in 2014, the survey found. That's a total whitewash. 58% of workers have more emergency savings than credit card debt, compared to 51% last year. One quarter of Americans also say they feel more secure in their jobs and are feeling better overall about their debt loads than any time since 2013. So folks are feeling good about being in record debt. And that is what a lot of the studies show. Economically, people are not in good shape, but they feel optimistic, at least if you believe these major studies that are coming out. And it's the way they phrase the questions. But here's what we know. Here is what we know. 100 million people plus, it's like 103 million, are not in the workforce. Around 50 million are on food stamps. They say 47 million, but if you count supplemental and other state-type systems, it's more like 55 million are on food stamps. Never before has the debt versus savings ratio been higher across the board. And it's only intensifying. And then what you pay for, you don't get as much value for. Big example is education. And I'm not here being a gloom and doomer, but they sell the idea that being positive will just make things better and create optimism in the economy. And that is the truth if you already have a good economy and aren't a one-crop system. But we don't have an industrial base. Our service base is eroding. Our jobs are being transferred overseas faster than you can keep track of it. And they're bringing in giant skilled, but also even larger unskilled immigrant groups to debase and drive down wages. And it hurts every American and doesn't even end up helping the third world. There's a giant sucking sound worldwide. China's getting poorer. Mexico's getting poorer. India overall's getting poorer. It's not industrializing these countries. It's not creating valuable jobs that pay them enough to build a middle-class system that creates stability. Meanwhile, when we come back, Texas governor, since January 1st, we've had more than 20,000 people come across the border, CNS News. That ties into the City of Austin website. Austin Welcoming City, Sanctuary City. We're going to cover how they're basically paying to bring the illegal aliens in to then integrate them into the welfare system. And I'm going to tie that into the CBS News headline from last week. Border Patrol ordered not to arrest drunk drivers if they're illegals. In fact, reprint me that article, please. And in the memos, they said it's not your fault if they kill somebody.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex
this
Jones
is what's killing
and the GCN Radio Network.
The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we the Patriots hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Used since before the days of the Roman Empire to support the body's natural systems and enhance overall health. Introducing the new InfoWarsLife.com oil of oregano formulation, a highly advanced nutraceutical form of this key herb that has been traditionally used by civilizations for thousands of years to promote health. We have now procured the most high quality and potent forms of oregano oil on the market, sourced from top leading manufacturers to ensure a concentrated level of bioactive ingredients. Extracted directly from the wild herb and sealed in easy-to-use capsules, you will no longer need to endure the burning of liquid oregano on the tongue. Wild-crafted from the Mediterranean oregano species that experts agree is one of the most powerful and most challenging to acquire. This winter season, it's more important than ever to secure this true form of oil of oregano. Now available in our limited first run at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139.
You are listening to an InfoWars.com frontline report. It's Alex Jones.
And if you're receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. We have the Trans-Pacific Partnerships and other global agreements right now being pushed through by stealth. They're completely secret. The public is not even allowed to see them. Congress is not allowed to see them. And they're trying to vote for fast track for the president, where he doesn't ever have to make any of it public. Did you hear me? Meanwhile, we caught the government last year, and later the New York Times confirmed it, shipping the illegals in and paying for their bus vouchers, where they're then shipped to sanctuary cities like Austin, Texas, and Chicago, Illinois, where the illegals are then basically given driver's license and allowed to vote. Do you remember the House and Senate of Illinois last year unanimously passed a bill to let, quote, anyone in the world come to Illinois and, quote, vote? Why do the feds put up with this? Because the feds are behind it. We have a captured federal government. And they spin the whole thing like, well, you got to accept immigrants and give them free welfare and let them have their babies here. Remember CNN last week? Chinese women by the thousands a month, and now it's growing to the tens of thousands a month. Save their money, fly here a month before they have their baby, check into a hotel, the baby gets citizenship, then they get citizenship, everything paid for, and then the husband is allowed to be brought in because they're now U.S. citizens, because the baby's a U.S. citizen. What was the headline from CNN? There it is. Why Chinese moms want American babies? Should be, you know, how American taxpayers are put on the hook for hundreds of thousands of dollars a year. Yeah, the average birth in the California hospital is $57,000, the LA Times reported last year. $57,000. If you went to China and said, I'm here to have my baby free, they'd arrest you. If you go to Mexico and say, I'm here to have my baby free, they would laugh at you. Oh, you can have your baby. We're going to throw you in jail, and Protective Services is going to take your kid, and we're going to adopt it. Oh, but we're not racist. Oh, you're from China? You're from Mexico? You're from Nigeria? Come here and have your baby, and we'll pay for it. Oh, you're Somalis? Oh, you say you want to come over here and blow up the shopping mall? Here, let us bring you in as part of a refugee program. Meanwhile, Texas governor, since January 1st, we've seen 20,000 people come across the border. We saw what happened on the Texas border last summer, but we need to understand that the problem is not going away. So Governor Greg Abbott told CBS's Face the Nation with Bob Schaefer Sunday. Already this calendar year, since January 1st, we've had more than 20,000 people come across the border apprehended, unauthorized, and so we have an ongoing problem on the border that Congress must step up to solve. The problem is Obama is down there. We know because the Border Patrol called us, we went and broke it in June of last year, that they load them on the buses in McAllen and Brownsville and every other city. They give them vouchers. They're bused to Democratic areas, Democratic cities, more than 80, well, there's 87 admitted sanctuary cities, Denver, Houston, Austin, San Antonio, Chicago, New York City of all places, L.A., and Portland, Oregon, Seattle, Washington, and you get there, there's the headline, city official admits Border Patrol fronting cash to bus illegals anywhere in the U.S. And then once they get to the Catholic churches and the Protestant churches, they get federal money, by the way, Democratic Party homes get $7,000 a month per three people they house, then they sign them up for welfare. They start giving a cut of the welfare to the families as well. There are people I know all over Austin, lawyers, you name it, that sit on top of groups of hundreds of illegals and then demand basically more dito from them. They've had city council connected family members of city council arrested for baseball batting, you know, basements full of illegals. So this is an underclass being preyed on. Let's get that straight. I don't blame people in collapsing Latin America wanting to get up here. And quite frankly, they have conservative values, but they're being indoctrinated and flipped and turned into operatives to vote, to take the guns, and to complete the takeover of this country. Their CBS News headline. Border Patrol agents advised to release drunk drivers. The memo says it doesn't matter if they kill people, it's not your fault. Of course, common law and state and federal does say that's illegal. But don't worry, a Justice Department memo by the same people that ship guns into Mexico to blame the Second Amendment. Do not detain. Isn't that just do not detain? And it just goes on to say, if you release them in the memo and they kill somebody, you are free from liability. No, you're not. But see, this is the age of government just doing whatever it wants because an usurper, globalist, foreign mega system is in control. Most of our laws are now written by the UN and then adopted outside of treaty by fiat by our local, state, and federal government under UNESCO treaties, under Agenda 21 from 1992 at the Rio Conference, under the Trans-Pacific Partnerships and the Pacific Union and the Asian Union and the North American Union and the Caribbean Union and all these interlocking systems. There's the headline, Judicial Watch, DHS orders Border Patrol to stop drunk driving arrest, but to continue it for citizens. Now, let's dovetail this open lawlessness, totally unfair, totally discriminatory, as we're merged by stealth into the North American Union. I like Greg Abbott overall. I know folks that know him personally. They say he's the real deal. He's battled Obama shutting down our power plants. He's battled him on the open border. But Abbott needs to come after the cities like Austin, Texas, where he got inaugurated a few weeks ago and they shut down half of downtown. I've talked to people that have had dinner with Abbott. He knows the whole show. He knows the New World Order. He knows what's going on. But Abbott, you need to talk about this. Look at this headline from austintexas.gov. Austin promotes immigrant-friendly, welcoming environment. Austin's hospitable reputation precedes itself once again with its new initiative designed to ease the transition to life in Austin for international newcomers. They're not even called migrants. They're just called international newcomers. But if you come from a wealthy Western country, let's just say it, it's discriminatory towards whites, they will throw the book at you, and you can't get your Ukrainian bride in, like one caller talked about. You can't get here with your PhD from South Africa if you're white. But if you are from a third world country and you're white with no skills, you can get in. If you're from a Latin American country with no skills, you can get in. If you're from Africa or Asia with no skills, you can get in. It is wide open. If you're destitute, a pregnant mother with two kids who got here on a train, baby, you're golden. Now, there is an event today and tomorrow at the Palmer Event Center. It's totally free. Listen to this headline. Welcoming America, a national grassroots-driven collaborative, yeah, by the Ford Foundation and the feds, works to promote mutual respect and cooperation in communities to help immigrants, they're already told everybody not to use the word illegal alien, and we all do what they say, into a social fabric of their adopted hometowns. Oh, it's their hometown now. And has also been recognized as a 2013 Clinton Global Initiative Commitment to Action. Global Initiative, that's under Agenda 21 United Nations Treaty. See that? That is UN. Austin's immigrant population is a key driver of economic prosperity. Really, look how economic prosperous this country is. This country's collapsing. And as an asset to our entire community, said Natalie Betts, the city of Austin's acting International Economic Development Program Manager. They have a program manager to literally give free food and board and welfare to the illegals. It is, quote, imperative for our continued success that new immigrants feel welcome. That's right, just like they make you feel welcome in other third world countries when you go down there. And at home in Austin, and I'm thrilled to be joining this national initiative to learn new welcoming strategies for our communities. That means how to give them all the welfare, all the free goodies, how to sign them up for everything. Welcoming cities and counties affiliates will share promising practices with each other and serve as a model to help communities across the nation learn from their local level innovations that support economic development and create vibrant global economies, communities that are great places to live, work, and do business. Now, I'm going to get into what they're doing at this event and who runs it in the cities that are part of this mutualization. Schwarzenegger said 5 years ago when the Copenhagen Treaty failed for global carbon taxes, he said, it doesn't matter. I'm going to head up the Global Communities Initiative to have local towns and cities implement Agenda 21 and the program. And then billionaires like him get city initiative money to build these dormitories that are 240 square feet under UN treaty, where they then house the illegals and pay for everything for them to displace American workers, drive down wages. As we just broke down, 4 out of 10 Americans are one bill from disaster. This is pure economic warfare by the ruling class. We've had professors on to break this down. The one from UC Davis to go over all this. And just the headlines pour in. Illegal alien prison riot leaves Texas facility in ruins. Unbelievable. McAllen, Texas. 2,000 inmates riot at South Texas prison. I mean, it is on. Inmates to be transferred after riot. I mean, and that's just where they're holding 2,000 of the aggravated felons. They just release everybody else. I mean, this is implosion level. So they're just doing it. Allegheny County, Pennsylvania, Austin, Texas, Baltimore, Maryland. This is who's part of this UN initiative under the Clintons. Boise, Idaho, Chicago, Illinois, Columbus, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, High Point, North Carolina, Lincoln, Nebraska, Macomb County, Michigan, Montgomery County, Maryland, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, St. Louis, Missouri County. And that's just this initiative. There's 80-plus sanctuary cities. Now, let's go into all the free goodies. Because remember the headline last week. Obama will give illegals day one a tax refund, even if they've just gotten here one day before. AP reported illegals, the banks with no ID, give them home loans. Because it's all there because the illegals are perfect. They'll work and get a welfare check, the perfect worker. So, because you can't live on the welfare and you can't live on the minimum wage, the illegals come from really hardcore serious countries and will work hard, but they'll also game the system. And the Ford Foundation, these welcoming committees, train them how to do it. They're not like lazy poor whites or poor blacks, on average. We've got the numbers, who will just welfare and lay there in a slum. The illegals want a new Chevy truck. They want to go on vacations. They want to go to nice restaurants, especially the Latin American ones. So they'll work two jobs and pull a welfare check. And they'll vote, and they'll become CPS workers, even when they're illegals. They'll become sheriff deputies, even when they're illegals. Look it up. AP reported a lot of illegals are now sheriff deputies. And now California, in just 1 week after the law went into effect, 59,000 immigrants with driver's license in the first month. You read deeper, though, in the AP article. That was actually numbers from the first week. Game over. The globalists have conquered every nation they want, and they're conquering us now. And the thing is, 80% or 81% of the immigrants are from Latin America. That's the favored group. And again, they've killed any type of race consciousness or culture consciousness in any other group. But with the Latin Americans, they hype it and push it because other folks can't hear it because it's another language. It's perfectly under the radar. You drive by and see billboards saying La Reconquista, La Raza. It means the race, the reconquering. You've got immigrant groups from South America saying, I have migrant rights as an indigenous. All this stuff taught out of the universities. So it's not like they're just going to come up here and work. They are becoming vehement collectivists, vehement communists, and being funded by the billionaires. Why is that? Because this is the political takedown game. Because the billionaires are offshore tax exempt. They don't go under this. But if you are a black American, a Hispanic American, a white American, an Asian American, a purple polka dotted American, a bright green American, I don't care what color your melanin is or where you came from, if you're a citizen or you're playing by the rules, they will screw you over 1,000 different ways. And the Democratic Party has an entire infrastructure like Acorn, Battleground Texas and all the rest of it, and that's who's involved in this, to radicalize and form these people into a cohesive block and to also milk them. Milk them. So this is a gang takeover. And the article continues. Registration, this is today, Monday, February 23rd, 2015. Registration, networking, and continental breakfast. General admission, free. And they go on, it's recommended that you leave room, be nice for the immigrants. So basically, don't come if you're not an illegal alien. Well, we're going to go down there and cover it. In fact, our guys are going down there today. I want a crew to go in 1 hour. Registration, networking, and continental breakfast. Networking. First, you identify any troublemakers. That's the networking. The change agents go around. Austin's multicultural demographic landscape. That's 9 to 10. That was last hour. The economic value of immigration in our community. Yeah, look at the country falling apart. Not immigration is good if they're hardworking and don't get welfare. But when you do, it brings the country down. Breakout. After lunch, the Texas League, executive action and the future potential of immigration reform. Total legalization. It's already been done by fiat. Breakout 2, career pathways for new Americans. You don't need to get citizenship. You just are. Because you're a Democrat, you're a socialist, you're a globalist. Plannery, best practices in immigration integration. All meals will be provided free of charge except for your own lunch on February 23rd, 2015. Please note that there is an $8 parking fee at the Palmer Event Center. And if you have questions, please contact Connie Gonzalez, connie.gonzalez@austintexas.gov, or her phone number. 2 weeks advance notice will allow us to provide seamless access. Where is the governor on this, Abbott? I mean, you want the illegals? They're right there being... It's fraud to put an illegal on welfare. It's fraud to help somebody with false IDs. But it's all just done right out in front of everybody. And I guarantee you, when we send our reporters down there, they're going to have reluctant cops down there getting in our face acting like we're criminals. Because we are criminals. When criminals take over... Those that aren't criminals are the enemy. What did George Orwell say? In a world of universal deceit, telling the truth is a revolutionary act. And when you live in a tyranny, if you lived in Nazi Germany and you were against the Nazis, you'd be called insane. This is America being conquered by global corporations that are doing this all over the world. Flooding. So there you go. Now, if you're a social worker learning how to help the illegals, you've got to pay $10 to go, though. So, but if you're an illegal, you're in like Flynn. Absolutely free. U.S. border agents in Tucson area told to let drunk drivers go free. See, I mean, it's just... But meanwhile, in Australia, national security, we're going to break this down when we come back. And it is an International Innovation Award, a partnership between the United Nations Alliance of Civilizations and BMW Group. So BMW is helping finance that. It's also here has the Carnegie Endowment. It's always the same people. Newman's Own Foundation. Yeah, when you buy Paul Newman stuff, it's going to open the borders up, bring people in and give them free goodies to break the country. And look, they get people like Paul Newman to sign on to this before he died. Believing he's helping poor immigrants. That's not what's going on. They use all these well-meaning people. Well, yes, we're Christians. Let's bring the poor Latin American children in and give them everything free as the national debt hits almost $19 trillion. I mean, this is designed to... People go to their mainline Methodist churches now that are begging for money, and then it goes to the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. They're just sucking money off all these well-meaning people. It's totally sick. And then America will collapse into a third-world slum like everywhere else, and the globalists will live in Monte Carlo, Luxembourg, or Switzerland, which do not allow this. And by the way, they're making Australia a safe haven for elites right now. They just voted out carbon taxes. London Guardian. National security. Abbott would revoke, not our Abbott, but the leader of Australia, would revoke citizenship as part of extremism fight, urges Muslim leaders to proclaim Islam as a religion of peace more often and mean it, and says if you engage or try to plan terrorism, you'll have your citizenship revoked. Absolutely. If you're not a born citizen and you commit terrorist acts, ship your butt out. Go kill each other on some desert island. I tell you, if they repeal their gun laws that they passed 20 years in Australia, it's looking better and better. That's another thing, folks. I'm not trying to run from all the immigrants. I'm trying to run from the globalist, organizing them into an army of ignorance. A perfect group that doesn't speak English, that are all balkanized in their own little slum-controlled areas, run by the big community organizer, Ford Foundation, UN garbage. I mean, this is global governance conquering sovereign nations and conquering the free market right now. This is the global elite that made their money in the robber baron age 150 years ago, pulling up the ladder so the rest of us can't get wealthy. They're teaching you get wealthy by working the system or being on welfare. Before I go any further, It is essential to spread the word about this broadcast. That's why we're growing by leaps and bounds. Thank you. It's having success. Keep spreading the word. Telling folks about the free podcast, the audio links, local AM and FM affiliates. And go to InfoWarsStore.com, where in the month of February, it ends in a few days, you can get 15% off, it's usually 10% off, with promo code WATER on all the high-quality water filtration systems. The best out there, very affordable, the best for the price, the Pro One and the clearly filtered systems. We have some others as well. They're all excellent. InfoWarsStore.com. Make the commitment to start drinking purified water as much as you can for you and your children and your family. Cut the glyphosates, the fluoride out, and then get the good halogen that blocks the fluoride. That's the Survival Shield X2. Get two bottles of that discounted right now. Get a free bottle of Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Booster at InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. And it's your purchase that funds the operation, so we salute all of you that are supporting. You are the tip of the spear. Stay with us. InfoWarsStore.com.
Visit GCNLive.com today.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
John McCain and Corker say court case, not DHS funding, is the best way to resolve Obama's executive amnesty. That means they know the court case will fail, not having Congress exercise its power over the purse. They don't want that precedent set. They're there to undermine the separation of powers and the continuity of our republic. Our country's been overrun by a bunch of usurpers who are busy trying to end the libertarian conservative voting bloc's attempt to block the world government takeover of the United States, not just the rest of the planet. Daniel Estulin will be joining us from Europe via video Skype with big news on Davos, the upcoming Bilderberg agenda. Some believe that they found the 2015 location. In fact, print me that article if you can. I think it was a Steve Watson article. Location 2015 found. Bilderberg, I think I'll pull it up. We're going to get into that with Estulin up until the bottom of the hour. Then more on the fresh nuclear leak detected at Fukushima plant. Coldest months on record, February 2015, could be among the top five in recorded history. James O'Keefe, we're going to try to get him on ASAP, folks. I'm afraid for my life. Journalist set to release bombshell story. He's released, let's not exaggerate, about five or six number one news stories in the U.S. that have brought down multi-billion dollar criminal operations like Acorn. He's been arrested, I think, about four times. They tried to indict him. So he's not a guy that cries wolf. He's not the boy that cries wolf. If he says he's afraid for his life with this story, he better release it now. Because Breitbart said, you know, he had the white whale, the big enchilada, the big one, and he was deader than a hammer. I wonder if O'Keefe dies real quick. They'll just say, oh, he had heart problems. It's no big deal. You know, I have been physically attacked. I have been death threatened. I have been trying to cover a military operation in Florida, And, man, they just green-lighted the craziest stuff, breaking our hotel room. They had some guy jump out of the bushes and just start setting fires, going, okay, Alex, I'll follow your orders to set fires. And I had to, like, put the fires out and get the start of a physical altercation. I pushed the guy down, and I said, listen, you may think you're tough. Because I knew he was former, he was obviously current military, but sheep dipped. He'd been following us around. I said, I'm about to hurt you, man. And I said, you may think you're going to get out of this, but, I mean, you're not going to set a fire in my name. So he ran off into the woods. Never saw him again. He'd been at Waco shadowing us. Mike Hansen saw all this happen. And he was a sheep dip type. They always infiltrate those guys. And they think you won't know they're military when they've got all the bearing and all the activity and are giving signals to the military you're tracking. They'll send in these little bitty guys, like you know, like 5'4". Because I had them one other time send one of those in on us. And they just think that you won't recognize their special forces when they send the little ones in. Those are the worst. And I mean, I've just dealt with stuff people wouldn't believe. And we went through all that. Word about it spread in the military. And I was told by a colonel in the Army about 5 years after all that happened. He said, man, you are a legend in special forces. And I said, what are you talking about? And they go, chasing the helicopters and putting guns to your head. Or it was actually to Mike's chest, but that the story changed a gun to my head. It wasn't my head. They said, turn that camera off in San Antonio. And we had the police chief throw them out. So we were down there 2 weeks later, and they got real mad. They still did the drill, and we got word. So the MP sticks a gun to Hansen's chest when he wouldn't give him the camera. And Hansen, oh, it was unbelievable. The problem is they took our tapes and erased them and then gave them back to us. But they all know it's true. So that's why that stuff then got exaggerated and all the stories got told to where they'd be doing these secret maneuvers. Because I was down there at Kingsville, San Antonio. Our reporters, auxiliary listeners were in Maryland, Alabama. We made films. There's video of this. Florida, L.A. And so the special forces started thinking it was me, but it was my listeners with cameras everywhere. And so I was like this boogeyman that was popping up during their drills. But it's funny how legends work. In fact, they still sometimes think I'm out there, and I haven't done that in probably 8 years. We'll be right back. Stay with us. From people on the periphery, but I do not have a source directly inside Bilderberg. But much of what they would cover at Bilderberg previously in secret is now rolled out publicly at Davos each year. Daniel Estulin has written several international bestsellers on the Bilderberg Group. He's also written a thinly veiled fiction that, of course, really isn't fiction at a lot of levels. Just like Ian Fleming's James Bond novels were true stories put into a composite. And he now has released a documentary we're going to be telling you about today. He joins us till 30 after, longer if he'd like. He's an author, public speaker, danielestulin.com, E-S-T-U-L-I-N.com. And his latest book is The Octopus Deception. And he joins us now to break down world government. We've gone from 15 years ago, mainstream media said it didn't exist. Now global government's here. Presidents in Italy are appointed because they're Goldman Sachs presidents. We see leaders appointed in other countries. We are now going into the technocratic era. That, of course, is a statement out of Bilderberg 6-7 years ago and from Davos last year. So really, they're coming out in the open. They're dissolving borders. They're passing global treaties without ratification. The text of the treaties are secret. Things are moving into high gear, and at the bottom of the rat hole is transhumanism, and Daniel will break that down. I want to look at the conflict with Russia. I want to look at what's happening in Europe, what's happening in Greece, standing up to Germany, at least on the surface. Daniel Estulin joins us via video Skype to give us a rundown on the latest unfolding worldwide. He also published his second book, released in 2006, described by Fidel Castro as a fantastic story. Castro wanted to meet him, so he went to Cuba to meet him. Estulin is not a communist, by the way, but I'd meet with Castro if I wanted to meet with him. The point is he's very influential because his analysis is cutting edge. And I happen to know who one of his Bilderberg sources is, by the way. Through Hollywood connections, I'll just leave it at that. So I know Estulin's for real, and his intel continues to come out and to be accurate year after year. So he's got the big scoop on where it may be held this year. Is it accurate, as some are saying, that it's going to be in Austria? and a lot more. Daniel, thank you for joining us.
Alex, it's always a great, enormous pleasure for me to be on the show. You and I go way back. In 2006, we had together, standing right in front of the Bilderberg Hotel in Kanata, Ottawa, when you were arrested, if you remember. Of course, you remember.
Yes.
Just before you came to Canada. And so we've been doing this for a long, long time. And, of course, Jim Tucker was with us. He's no longer with us. But there's a lot of people out there who are doing what they can to make sure that this story doesn't die. And, again, this global awareness, which you were talking about before, on the world stage, people are becoming aware more and more what's going on as a result of technological revolution, internet and everything else out there. It's getting more and more difficult for the global elite to hide their deeds. And as you said, we do have the sources. And I'm very glad you didn't actually give out the source we have through Hollywood, because these are some very, very influential and useful people for our cause.
Well, sure. I mean, of course, I'm not going to get into it, but I wasn't giving out a secret for those that know. But, and that's just one of your sources. But I'm just confirming that you know, some inside baseball for folks out there that know what we're talking about. Daniel, continuing looking at what's happening, why do you think they're coming show out in the open? And then you've got the floor, because I could ask questions, but I want to know what's on your mind, the latest intel you've gotten.
Well, the Bilderberg meeting is being held actually in 2015 in Austria on my Twitter account at Esterlin Daniel. I published a couple of months ago a report that I got from my intel sources in the Ministry of the Interior of Austria, who sent me the report saying which dates that everybody in Austria has to be on the lookout. There is no holidays that week. I believe it's from the 9th of, I can't remember exactly the date right now, but it's the beginning of June, and it is being held in Austria, and we have the documents to demonstrate it. As far as what's going on in the world, the globalist elite, the reason actually all this information is coming out right now, Alex, is that the global elite are faced with the reality of seeking to dominate populations that are increasingly becoming self-aware and are developing a global consciousness. Thus, a population being subjected to domination in Africa, for example, has the ability to become aware of a population being subjected to the same forms of domination in the Middle East, in South America, or in Asia, or even in Europe, in Greece, for example. And they can recognize that they're all being dominated by the same global power structures. And that is the key point. Not only is the awakening global in its reach, but also in its nature. It creates within the individual an awareness of the global condition. So it is a global awakening, both in the external environment and also in the internal psychology. And this is something that the elitists, such as the Bilderbergers, the Trilateral Commission, Council for Relations, Pinay Circle, Bohemian Grove, and all this, you know, ONGs, Rockefeller Foundations, Carnegie's, every, you know, Hudson's and Hoover's, they simply, you know, can't deal with it right now, because it's a new game. And this new reality in the world comes with the fact, Alex, that the world's population has never been so vast, presents a challenge to elites seeking to dominate people all over the world who are aware and awaken to the realities of social inequality, to war, poverty, exploitation, disrespect, imperialism, and domination. And of course, this directly implies that these populations will be significantly more challenging to control, both economically, politically, socially, psychologically, and also spiritually.
Simply amazing. You know, you, when I interviewed you for Endgame 8-9 years ago, you talked about at the bottom of the rabbit hole is eugenics, is transhumanism, that they don't need human populations anymore in large numbers. The decision has been made not to build a world where humans go to space and where we have human dignity, but where humans don't have dignity, so that we expect to be basically reclamated, destroyed, phased out. What's the latest intel in that area? What's the latest that happened behind the scenes at Davos? And what's going to be on the agenda, if you know so far, at the coming meeting in a few months there in Austria?
Well, I think, you know, as we've talked about, I think it was 6 or 7 months ago, my last book in the United States is actually called Trans-Evolution, The Coming Age of Human Deconstruction. And in that book, basically, I explain, and you know, you've been following this, and you've been talking about this, I think, longer than anybody in the world. You brought this to people's attention long before I decided to write this book, Trans-Evolution, that, you know, we're living through this greatest paradigm change in the history of the human, you know, planet Earth, of human society. And the changes we're seeing right now over the very short period of time into the future, you know, are so paramount that they will forever change the very face of humanity. For example, those of us who have children who today are 6, 7, 8 years old, you know, this is, you could pretty much safely say that this is the last 100% human generation of people on the planet Earth. Our grandchildren, they will not be human. They'll be transhuman, they'll be post-human, they'll be man-machines, they'll be cyborgs, they'll be beings who are not totally human as a result of incredible revolution in synthetic biology. So again, we're seeing this change from human to transhuman to post-human, and this change is going to lead to a completely different state of a human being into the very near future. And again, we're talking about progress and technological development, which the elite are using for their own advantage, because again, the point is, if using technology to increase the power of man over nature, that's an amazing thing. It's a positive thing. But if you're using technology to subjugate us a lot more than we already are subjugated, because there's a lot more people, it's a small planet with limited natural resources. So you have, you know, 1% against 99%, and for the Rockefellers of this world to eat, most of us have to die. I mean, you've talked about this ad nauseum in your documentaries, and I was honored, actually, to participate in one of them.
Well, we were honored to have you, Daniel. We're going to talk about your documentary here in a moment and skip this network break, because all the time we have with you is so precious. But expanding on that, the way you quantify it in your latest book, which was just excellent research and material, I learned a lot reading it, is we've got to put that out there, that that's the choice. They're building a world to get rid of us where we don't exist. That's the global architecture. That's what the social engineers are going for now. 50 years ago, there was a debate about it. Now that group has taken control. That's why things are moving so quickly. People need to know the future of our world has been decided if we let these people run things. But if the population is aware of their program, then all of this deindustrialization, all of this dehumanization will then make perfect sense and we can stop it. I mean, Daniel, I don't see how they can get their program if you and I and countless others are exposing it. And like you said, 20 years ago, no one was talking about this. Now, this is becoming very, very mainstream, and I don't see how they're going to sell the idea of something so monstrous.
Well, you know, a great example, and I think, you know, the greatest living example is Detroit. I mean, if you want to talk about deindustrialization, zero growth, demand destruction, all you need to do is look at Detroit. This was the, you know, the engine of economic growth and industrial might in the United States for the past half a century. Today, it looks like something you see in a Will Smith, you know, zombie post-apocalyptic film. And of course, people who live in the United States, who live in Detroit, who live in Michigan, or who live, you know, anywhere, and who are aware of what's going on in Detroit, have to understand that this is a prototype for the globalist elite for the rest of the world. They want the rest of the world, and you've talked about this, I think, again, longer than anybody I know, they want the rest of the world to look like Detroit, London to look like Detroit, Paris to look like Detroit, you know, Moscow to look like Detroit. And if you kind of look at Europe, I mean, Greece already looks like Detroit. Portugal looks like Detroit. In Spain, you have 70% youth under 30 unemployed. Italy, you know, is up in arms. Half of the country, you know, from Rome down, is pretty much unemployed. Anywhere you go, you know, the world is up in arms. South America, Southeast Asia, you know, Canada, you know, Africa, you know, these places, this is what deindustrialization looks like. And again, if people are wondering why the elite are doing this, progress and development is directly proportional to population density. So if you have progress, you have technological, you know, development and industrial development, you're going to have more wealth, more money, greater families, which means you're going to have more mouths to feed. And so for the Rockefellers of this world to eat, you know, we have to die. It's really that simple. There's simply not enough food. There's enough space for now, but there's not enough food. So which is why, on the one hand, what they're doing, and I talk about this in Trans-Evolution, and you pointed out to me very well, this is exactly what they're doing. On the one hand, they're destroying the world's economy on purpose, the elite. But on the other hand, they're using their gazillions of their monies to actually invest in this incredible futuristic technology, which will make this divide between their power over the rest of humanity greater than ever.
By the way, we're rolling some background footage of your new film, and I tell you, it looks like better than something you'd see on HBO. the camera work, the research. I cannot wait to see this. Tell us about your new documentary, Daniel, and how soon we can get a copy of it. I'd love to sell it on DVD or Blu-ray once it comes out at my store, but I hope it goes in theaters first. Tell people the name. Tell us all about this incredible documentary on the Bilderberg Group that you produced.
Well, we're in a post-production now. The film comes out at the end of May, beginning of June. We've been at it for about 4 years. It's our production. We've done interviews in 11 countries, Canada, the United States, most of Europe. We've traveled up and down all over the place. The first producer of the documentary was actually wiped out economically, if you believe in conspiracy or coincidence theories, when three banks called in loans on the same day and basically bankrupted him. So he actually
had to pull a lot of- And by the way, I separately know about this, not from you, but I know who the group was. Are we allowed to say who they were, or we shouldn't talk about it?
You can if you want, exactly.
Was that the guys with the Halcyon Group?
No. The Halcyon Group, Major Motion Picture.
Yeah, that's the folks that made Terminator, that they also came after them and took them over to stop your film getting made, right?
These are not the people who are producing the documentary. These are other people in Spain, independent producers, people who...
So this has happened twice then, if I'm correct.
This happened twice, once with the Major Motion Picture, and now with the documentary, which is why it took us a bit longer. But it's almost in the post-production stages. I tell you a little anecdote. I sent a letter, an email to Martin Wolf, the Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist with the Financial Times, and I asked him for an interview, and I got a reply, and of course we're going to put it in the documentary. He sent an email, how dare you make a documentary about the Bilderberg Group. So the documentary is coming out at the beginning of June, end of May. We're in the post-production, and... You know, we're very, very close to the finish line. We're going to be over that finish line, and the film is going to be out. Worldwide release. There's a lot of international, large film festivals who are very interested. And also, Bilderberg has become a household name. The book came out 10 years ago, and now everybody knows about it. And I think this is the time. It's the right time, socially speaking, with all the changes taking place in the world, that people think finally are ready to embrace this concept that you've been talking about for about over a decade. And, you know, I've been talking about it for over a decade.
Well, you've got Nigel Farage in here. You've got just an amazing list of top people in your film. I cannot wait to see this. What's the name of the film?
It's called The True Story of the Bilderberg Group. It's based, obviously, on my book. It's actually the first documentary which is based on a book. Most documentaries, you know, are not based on books. But this one is based on my book, The True Story of the Bilderberg Group. I get it's going to be out in theaters end of May, beginning of June. And... when it's out, needless to say, I'd be more than happy and pleased to go back on your show and talk about it.
Incredible. Well, I'm thinking about going to Austria. I'll just give them a heads up like I did in England. They had British intelligence domestically there waiting for me when I got off the plane to have a little talk with me, and then I had to meet with the local multi-county group. But they ended up being pretty nice and helping us out and ended up not liking the Bilderberg group too much. But I am going to give the Germans and the Austrians a heads up that I'm coming. I know it's two different countries, but the two work closely together. I wonder what reception I'll get in Austria. How do you expect them to treat the press, Daniel?
Not very well. It's you know, if you're talking about jackboot, this is, you know, the epitome of jackboot. Austria, Germany, and Switzerland. I mean, you pretty much, you know, these are... If you want to talk about, you know, Soviet Gulag, this is the European, German, Austrian, Swiss version of the Soviet Gulag, modified and needless to say.
Sure. Well, you live over there, and you lived in Russia and Spain and everywhere else, and Canada. So I know you're internationally, you know, traveled. So I don't know. I haven't been to Austria yet. I know it's kind of a paradox, though, because the British ended up really hating Bilderberg and agreeing with me, the police, off record. And, I mean, a bunch of them. You know, had police buying me beer and stuff when they would, you know, see me at the pub down the street getting dinner. So that was pretty amazing. And then when we had our reporters in Switzerland a few years ago, at first the police were real mean, but later they were escorting members of the local canton into the meeting, getting in the face of Bilderberg, and they panicked and had jet copters taking off at night, which I know you know about. So what do you make of kind of this awakening, even by local government, to Bilderberg?
Well, you know, I can tell you that in 2011, Mario Borghesio was European parliamentarian. He was actually punched out by the Swiss police, and he spent a couple of nights in a hospital.
Trying to show him.
This is a member of the European Parliament, and you know, I had to explain to Mario Borghesio. I said, Mario, Switzerland is not Europe. Switzerland is Switzerland. It's like another planet. It has nothing to do with Europe. So him coming in with his European member of the European Parliament pass makes absolutely no difference, because literally like walking into a, you know, closed off gulag. And Austria, I fear, is going to be pretty much the same thing. It's a small country. It's a pipsqueak nation. And needless to say, you know, they have unresolved childhood issues, which they haven't been able to deal with since the Hitlerite days.
Are you going to be there?
I'm certainly going to try. You know, it all depends on the documentary. If it comes out, I may not be able to, maybe promoting the film. But if I'm not, I'm certainly going to be there. If you're interested, after the interview, I'm going to send you the documents I received from my sources. You're more than welcome to post them on your site, from the Ministry of the Interior of Austrian Secret Service, explaining about the Bilderberg community to the people in the ministry, so that they're aware which days they can and cannot take off, you know, leaves of absence.
Incredible. Well, I can't wait to see your film. It just looks like a smash hit. And, you know, Snowden's new film, Citizen 4, won an Oscar for Best Documentary. That's why they're so scared and said, how dare you? They know that you're really trying to make, you know, full-budget, professional, powerful film. And I just can't wait to see you in the last 4 years working on this to get this out. DanielEstlin.com. In closing, I know you've got sources. I know a lot of it now is pretty much, as you said last time you were on, is put out at Davos. But what's on the agenda for 2015 in Switzerland or in Austria?
One of the key issues, Alex, is fiscal austerity. You know, this boogeyman term is back. It's kind of a vague term that is, you know, actually refers to cutting social spending and increasing taxes. And the effect this has is that the public sector is devastated, as all assets are privatized, public workers, you know, are fired en masse, unemployment becomes rampant, health and education disappear, taxes rise dramatically, and currencies are devalued to make all assets cheaper for international corporations and banks to buy up, while internally causing inflation, dramatically increasing the costs of fuel and food. And in short, fiscal austerity implies social destruction, as we're seeing right now in Greece, as we saw in Spain, as we saw in Portugal, and as we're seeing, you know, in Italy. And, you know, the social destruction of the social foundations of nations and peoples are pulled out from under them. States then become despotic and oppress the people who naturally revolt against austerity. And this is called the sterilization of society. And this is the term, again, this is the term, Alex, you're going to be seeing a lot more, you know, with the build-up to Bilderberg and then post-Bilderberg. We talked about this before, you know, terms like deindustrialization, zero growth, demand destruction. You know, they were discussed at these private secret meetings, and then suddenly they were front and center in major newspapers. Next big front and center newspaper piece is sterilization of society. It sounds awful, just the word sterilization itself with all the connotations. When you start sterilizing society, it takes on a meaning of its own. It takes it, you know, to an nth degree, you know, of evil that, needless to say, we have to make sure we fight this.
When they say sterilization, do they mean sterilization physically, which we know is part of their agenda, population reduction? Or does it mean kill upward mobility, stagnate, make people poor, and basically create a class society in the name of collectivism?
It's more, you know, meaning austerity. So as austerity hits, for example, the West, the middle class will vanish in obscurity as they will be absorbed into the lower labor-oriented working class. The youth of the Western middle class, comprising the majority of the educated youth, will be exposed to a poverty of expectations in which they grew up, in a world in which they were promised everything, in which these kids played by the rules, and which, you know, they got nothing from society. And the inevitability.
I tell you what, Daniel, I don't want to cut you off. I know you got to go, but do 5 more minutes with us if you can. I'm going to twist your arm. DanielEstlin.com. I want you to finish up. So thank you so much on what their agenda is straight ahead. And then we'll cover world news and economic news after he leaves us. More with Daniel Estlin straight ahead. I'm Alex Jones.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Used since before the days of the Roman Empire to support the body's natural systems and enhance overall health. Introducing the new InfoWarsLife.com oil of oregano formulation, a highly advanced nutraceutical form of this key herb that has been traditionally used by civilizations for thousands of years to promote health. We have now procured the most high quality and potent forms of oregano oil on the market, sourced from top leading manufacturers to ensure a concentrated level of bioactive ingredients. Extracted directly from the wild herb and sealed in easy-to-use capsules, you will no longer need to endure the burning of liquid oregano on the tongue. wild-crafted from the Mediterranean oregano species that experts agree is one of the most powerful and most challenging to acquire. This winter season, it's more important than ever to secure this true form of oil of oregano. Now available in our limited first run at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139. The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we, the Patriots, hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
Careful what you wish. You just might get it.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
Daniel was kind enough to hold over another 5-10 minutes because he was kind enough to send over a list of topics he'd like to get into. And, of course, I never brought any of them up. So I want to go over this with him quickly. Greece's economic meltdown and bailout. What's the real story? Could Europe be the new Japan? Putin, Russia, and Ukraine war. Results of Davos summit. We kind of hit on that. 70th anniversary of Yalta conference. Daniel was invited to give a keynote speech for the Russian government. That's a big deal. That was when Stalin, Churchill, and, of course, the U.S. president at the time, he died shortly after, Roosevelt all met. And the post-world plan was set up. Copenhagen terrorist attack. And we already talked about trans-evolution, transhumanism. But he joins us right now from Europe. Daniel, continuing, let's run through what's in store in the agenda and then these points.
Maybe it was just, as we have very little time, maybe just touch on a couple of things. One is Russia-Ukraine. And the other is the situation with the ECs, because it all kind of ties in with what's happening in the, you know, with deindustrialization, et cetera. I think it's, you know, it's fairly obvious when we're talking about, you know, the whole issue between Russia and the United States and NATO. It's not Ukraine. It's the determination of governments that are under the thumb of the London Wall Street financial oligarchy to crush any sovereign opposition to their power. And the powerful nations committed to defending national sovereignty, especially Russia and China, are thus de facto their enemies, and any lies necessarily to justify that, you know, the designation will be and are being used. And the truth is being overwhelmed by a torrent of lies about Russian aggression, you know, suppressing the real story of the coup d'etat in Ukraine, the Nazi nature of the coup plotters themselves, and also the strategic intentions, you know, behind the plot. And we're seeing that, and it's amazing how easily the Americans can be confused and lied to and accept, you know, the propaganda of the White House and the Western elite.
That's right. Copenhagen terrorist attack. What do you think is going on there?
Well, if you kind of go back, Alex, to, I don't know if you remember back in 2005, the famous Politiken cartoons. These are the first, Mohammed cartoons, which were released in 2005 by this Danish newspaper called the JT Politiken. So under the guise of free speech, this newspaper, they published a dozen provocative anti-Islamic cartoons clearly designed to offend the Muslims. We've seen this again with Charlie Hebdo. We're seeing it right now, what's going on in Denmark. But if you kind of look at what's going on, all these characters, whether it's Sarkozy's, Cheney's, Rumsfeld, Netanyahu's, Jack Straw's, Obama's, Bush's, all of these people that march into the martial music of the neocons, that the shock troops of the Clash of Civilizations, Project for New American Century, the Long War, Clean Break, and all these other neocon plots, conspiracies, and contrivances. And once again, the question is, who benefits? Enters the equation. Muslims, they may burn off some of the outrage of what they see as denigration, of the religion. But at the end of the day, the Straussian, Habotinsky liquidite coalition, they score some very big propaganda points. And once again, people in America and Europe who must be periodically reminded of the necessity for this clash of civilizations agenda for total war are incensed by the violence spreading across the Middle East and are convinced that all Muslims are crazed fanatics who must ultimately be dealt with and put to death. And so when you kind of look at it from that perspective, you ask yourself, who wins? Well, this is the situation. And going back, putting all these things, from a bird's eye view into perspective, ISIS, Ukraine, deindustrialization in America, what's going on? Well, we all know what ISIS is. But, with its fingertip control of the world's oil supplies, ISIS is holding the economies and hence the governments of Western Europe and Japan hostage to the same policy. And with its networks of mullahs and kooks distributed throughout the Middle East, it is threatening the Arab world with the hell of more Iran, if Arab governments do not play along with the Islamic card and seize their aspirations for industrial development. But again, these people are not new. ISIS, we saw this with the Muslim Brothers going back 7 years. It's the same thing as Al-Qaeda. This is a very old strategy. For at least 150 years, Alex, it has been the strategy of the British and later the Anglo-Americans to make use of the religious and tribal backwardness of the nations of the near Middle East and Central Asia in order to control the people of the area and to maintain them in a state of underdevelopment. It has recently become obvious, that we've seen years back in the 1990s with Zbigniew Brzezinski's book, it has been sold on the idea that the Muslim fundamentalists, if properly guided, can be useful toy, for the Anglo-American strategy as a bulwark against anything that has to do with progress and development.
And what's amazing about listening to you, Daniel Estulin, is that you're quoting here from Brzezinski's book, you're quoting from the Grand Chessboard, you're quoting from the Great Game that the British talked about in India, where they would play different Indian tribes off against each other. How could you have one British, on average, conquer over 2,000 Indians with just a few thousand? It was using sociology to play different groups off. And so the globalists fund the radical Muslims, turn them loose, so it is a real issue. It is disgusting what they're doing. But then they open the borders, bring them in, let them attack, then take our liberties, and then go and take over and kill the innocent Muslims en masse. This is the globalist manipulating all sides against each other and then writing books about their grand strategy. And the public needs to wake up to this and needs to understand it. Daniel, folks can follow you on Twitter. What's the best Twitter account for them to follow you at?
It's at Estulin Daniel. Also, as I said, the documentary is just about to be done. And I don't know if I mentioned, I don't think I did, but I was recently nominated for Nobel Peace Prize for all the work I have done over the years in fighting this globalist elite. So again, I think there's a lot of recognition being done and made on the world stage, not only for the things that I do, but also for this, again, for this change of consciousness in society. Which is going towards this greater collective good, which is actually what we need, to actually defeat these people, defeat the elitists, and have a better future for our children.
Well said. God bless you. Thank you so much, Daniel.
Thank you, Alex, so much for being on your show.
Absolutely. Again, Daniel's books have sold number one bestseller in more than 15 countries, and a lot of Americans wouldn't know who he is. A lot of folks in Europe and Asia know who he is. It just shows how many great people there are out there fighting tyranny. And he's taken action. He's got a film coming out. That makes me feel good knowing there's more people out there fighting, not just myself or our listeners. We're going to talk about James O'Keefe, says he's afraid for his life. Journalist set to release bombshell story. What could it be? Paul Joseph Watson is going to put out another report looking at, you know, perhaps what it could be. We're calling O'Keefe right now, trying to get him on today or tomorrow, and, you know, advising him that he needs to just release the story. Because he's never hyped something that didn't end up being bombshell, and he's never talked like this before, so I think he may be in real danger. Believe me, folks, I've been death threatened more times than you can imagine, and I've had a lot of serious dirty tricks pulled on me. And let me tell you that the system will resort to dirty tricks. He's been arrested. They've threatened to indict him. He brought down Akern. He's done so many other big things, and they just don't like knowing he's out there. They don't like knowing we're out there or Daniel Estlin's out there. Jim Tucker got shot at in Portugal. All sorts of other dirty tricks they pull. And I'm not up here saying, oh, you know, aren't we cool? We're such heroes. I'm just breaking down the fact that once you get involved in this at this level, it's not fun. But it's very rewarding at a spiritual level to know that you're affecting change. And it's also very frustrating because then you understand, wow, good people really could take back the world. We really could defeat evil and corruption, but we just give the world to the establishment and act like we have no power. Now, before I get into this news and a bunch of other news that I've not gotten to yet here today, ahead of Joel Skousen of World Affairs Brief, the editor of World Affairs Brief, joining us, I wanted to just briefly tell you about some things that if you will take action and actually use them, I believe, because it's done that for me, will change your life. We have gravity-fed G2, super high quality, the entire family of filters and accessories for the Pro 1, Pro Pure, G2.0 filters. It takes out the fluoride, everything, the glyphosate, you name it. We also have the clearly filtered systems that are excellent as well, but less expensive. We also have the gravity-fed tabletop filters that are very affordable and very easy to use. These are all stainless steel units when you talk about Pro Pure. We have the other least expensive systems that are not stainless steel, but it's all there. And the globalists are really hitting us with all the toxins that are in the water. They're by accident, they're on purpose. The weed killer runoffs, the pesticides, the mercury, the lead, the arsenic, the hydrofluorosilicic acid, different fluoride breakdown derivatives. It is a no-brainer to start filtering your water today. Just get one for work, get one for home. If your kids are going off to college, give it to them and say, listen, I'll help you out with your car payment, you know, in 6 months if you commit to me that you're just going to drink water out of this filter system. Changing our lifestyle one day at a time is the way to go. And you can do it over time. You can do it effectively. And so that's what I want to challenge people to do today, is to take action, is to get involved, and to also financially support this operation. When you go to InfoWarsStore.com and you buy a pro-gun or pro-liberty anti-tyranny t-shirt, they're great designs. We've got a whole Made in America section. When you support us, you fund everything we're doing. And I know you know that consciously, but I need that to sink in. Some months it's hard for us to keep operating. Some months we have fat times. I'm able to expand something or fund a trip or fund some investigative journalism. But we need the funds to cover Bilderberg. We need the funds to cover different events around the world. We need the funds to keep these reporters and maybe get a few extras so we're not stretched thin. And the writers and researchers and the folks behind the scenes and the folks that make this whole operation possible. So again, InfoWarsStore.com. In a couple days, we end the special, 15% off, promo code WATER at checkout. You get 15% off all the water filters and accessories. We already have the lowest price out there on the family of water filter systems that we have. We've got taste test videos in Austin with real people, 9 out of 10 choosing our water over the leading competitor. InfoWarsLife.com is the place to go, where you can get two bottles of the incredible true deep earth crystal source nascent iodine, the good halogen that has done so much for my body. You've heard the rave reviews. And you get a free bottle of Ancient Defense Right Side, that's our brand, of ancient herbal immunity defense. Ancient Defense. These are tried and true, purified, organic, concentrated, laundry list of known herbs and fruit extracts, supercharge immunity and health. Amazing. I take it every day. My children take it every day. We've been super healthy this winter by the grace of God when last winter was so hellish. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. Whether it's t-shirt questions or ball cap questions or belt buckle questions or book or film questions or the different nutraceutical questions about lung cleanse or our proprietary colloidal silver that's Rolls-Royce quality at Ford Taurus cost. Not that the Ford Taurus is a cheap car, it's just compared to Rolls-Royce. It's all there at InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or 888-253-3139. Now, that's got all of our proprietary products on those two sites. Another excellent family of nutraceuticals are the Longevity line, the Pollen Burst that I even promote and sponsor. I'm even on the package. The best energy drink with the bee pollen and a bunch of other stuff and the B vitamin spectrum in there. The Beyond Tangy Tangerine 2.0 in two different flavors and over 400 other products are just off the charts good. They're excellent. And you can support the broadcast purchasing those products at InfoWarsTeam.com or InfoWarsHealth.com. You can also sign up there and get auto ship. And when you sign up and get auto ship there, you can get free shipping on the products. You can also call 888-789-9277, 888-789-9277, InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsHealth.com, InfoWarsStore.com. You can also find the book Epigenetics that is just mind-blowing in how much sense it makes in the research by Dr. Joel Wallach there at InfoWarsHealth.com as well. And finally, please support our local AM and FM affiliates. Support their sponsors. Tell friends and family about them. Become a sponsor. Make a donation. Keep us on the air. We're getting new affiliates, but it's vital to support them. And we salute and thank all of our affiliates out there. Now, let me get into the James O'Keefe story, then we'll go to break, come back with the coldest months on record, what that means to the global warming fraudsters. But here's the article up on InfoWars.com with his tweet. We have a story we're going to release this week, this coming week, and I've never thought about this before, but I'm afraid for my life on this one. Conservative filmmaker James O'Keefe is about to release a bombshell story that has the journalist fearing for his life, Paul Joseph Watson article. InfoWars.com. We have a story. We're going to release this coming week. I've never thought about this before, but I'm afraid for my life on this one, O'Keefe tweeted Saturday. Whatever its nature, the story promises to be a big one given the impact generated by O'Keefe's previous work. In 07, O'Keefe poses a donor wanting to give money to Planned Parenthood to pay for the abortion of black and other minority babies. Workers at numerous Planned Parenthood clinics agreed to accept the donations on the terms, and sickeningly had creaminess in their voices going, oh, yes, the black ones, yes. O'Keefe's biggest scalp was undoubtedly his 2009 takedown of Acorn, an advocacy organization for people on low income. Hidden camera footage published by O'Keefe showed Acorn employees giving advice on how to evade detection for tax evasion, human smuggling of child prostitution. Congress voted to eliminate federal funding for Acorn as a result of the expose. We can bring down these other groups, folks. In August of 2014, O'Keefe demonstrated the porous state of the U.S. border when he crossed an unguarded footbridge in the upper Rio Grande while dressed as Osama bin Laden. And see, we need to send our reporters in just to sit there today And just to listen at these meetings they're having in Austin with this Austin Welcomes UN-funded program where they hand out all the free goodies and tell the illegals how to get all the welfare. For O'Keefe's sake, let's hope that this doesn't end up like Andrew Breitbart, the conservative journalist, who weeks before his untimely death on March 1st, 2012, promised to release devastating video footage of President Obama. Wait till they see what happens March 1st, Breitbart told an audience in Washington, D.C. And of course, he was dead. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
This hour brought to you by InfidelBodyArmor.com. When it hits the fan, don't be left without the body armor that will save your life. With prices starting at just $374.99 and ships free. Get yours at InfidelBodyArmor.com. Just won't quit.
Hi, Ted Anderson with Midas Resources. Is it time to convert paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver yet? Get our 10 Reasons book free. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
It's time to kick some ash. Because cigarettes have met their match. Smokers are switching to Vapriate e-liquid by LeSig. Because when you kick ash, you kick tar and smelly smoke too. LeSig smokes the competition with real people customer service, a 7-day satisfaction guarantee, and same-day fast free shipping. Become a vapor today at LeSig.com. Spelled LeCig.com. LeSig e-cigarettes. Kick some ash.
The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we, the Patriots, hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. Simply Safe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, Simply Safe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it. And that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. Simply Safe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. Simply Safe. Go to SimplySafeDefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's SimplySafeDefense.com.
Story just went live on InfoWars.com, an exclusive, and we're beefing the article up, adding more documentation about how it's UN-funded. We already have direct links on the site. Dozens of cities host welcoming committees for illegals. Austin, Texas, and other cities showering illegals with free goodies in UN-sponsored program. Dozens of cities across America organizing welcoming committees to help illegals adjust to life here in the United States. The cities are partnering with a group called Welcoming America, which is funded by the UN and part of the Clinton Foundation. In fact, he was asking me for that. He wrote this article, and I had my stack. Will you guys give him the city of Austin stack? Because I had that here, and I wanted to direct him to the city of Austin to add that part.
Okay, no
problem. To the article, or you found it multiple times, CJ. Here it is. Here it is. I've got it right here. It's the Clinton Global Initiative, and if you look at that, that's a UN-funded program. Give him that. I want a screenshot of the Clinton-funded deal with the city seal above it. Thanks. People don't believe this stuff, so we got to show it to them. This is a premeditated takeover plan. So dozens of cities host welcoming committees, and we got a screenshot off the website where it's an international operation of the United Nations Alliance of Civilization and BMW Group. Well, that's what you know about BMWs. They got nice cars. But what's wrong with those Germans? Well, the Germans got captured after World War II, and one evil got replaced with another under the Marshall Plan, which they used to take the country over. Same thing's happening in Ukraine, a new Marshall Plan for them. There it is, CGI America, commitment to action. Part of the Clinton Global Initiative commitment to action. So he does have it in the article. Continuing, we welcome dreamers from around the world, and it keeps us young, and it keeps us invigorated, and it keeps us thriving and pushing the boundaries of what's possible, Obama said of the group on December 9th of last year. And this article goes over all of it. Very important article. And I forgot to get to this. Last week I shot a special report on it, but will you guys print me the article, resembling a rapist can ruin your education? I mean, this is political correctness now, where a woman claims she was raped somewhere else years ago, says a man looks like it, so they kick him off the campus. And then in Europe, they're banning scores of names of birds like Schwarzbird. You know, we say, hey, look at those blackbirds. Well, that's racist. See, what they're doing is they're turning language into a crime where people can't even communicate. Look at that Schwarzbird. Sorry, that's racist. They're officially changing in the ornithology community, the names, as if. And then I noticed this weekend, and I looked it up, I wanted to report on it. They're no longer, I was driving in the car, and it said the city of Austin had a big billboard up, sponsored by the city of Austin, taxpayer money again, just like this illegal alien event with these goodie bags and free food for 2 days is sponsored. And it said, Happy Lunar New Year. It's the Chinese New Year. But see, it's racist to say the word Chinese. It's like saying, I want American food, a hamburger. Because it'll say American cuisine. Is that right? I mean, of course not. They've got us all obsessing over things that don't exist or don't matter, while the real discrimination of foreign megabanks above the law signing us on to quadrillions in fake debt, Obamacare, a giant scam, doubling, tripling prices, death panels, insurance company profits up threefold in the U.S., 49% worldwide because of the gang raping. Look at this article. Innocent college student subjected to restraining order for resembling alleged rapist. This is from the Harvard Law Review. We wrote a story about it. Mikhail Thalen did. And we're not making this up. Female has male student banned from campus for triggering rape memories. This is a license for totalitarianism by protected groups that are foot soldiers of the collective is taking over. This is a cult. This is a death cult of mafia crazies.
The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we, the Patriots, hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
In don't tell me that I'm a weirdo because I'm upset about this.
I'm just sick of dishonorable trash.
Supreme Cobra Commander!
You're failures! You think I'd sell my family out like you, dirtbag?
Jakari Jackson for Infowars.com. Campus rape is a very serious allegation and should be treated as such. But what if you, an innocent person, are caught up in the net and are being punished for a crime that you did not commit? Innocent college student subject to restraining order for resembling alleged rapist. An innocent male student was reportedly banned from entering large areas of his liberal arts school in Oregon after a female classmate accused him of slightly resembling a rapist she encountered months prior in another state. He was ordered to stay away from a fellow student, cutting him off from his housing, his campus job, and educational opportunity, all because he reminded her of a man who had raped her months before and thousands of miles away, said Professor Janie Haley of the Harvard Law Review. Which is to say, after a thorough investigation, this man has been proven innocent, but is still being punished for a crime that he did not commit. And all due sympathies to the young lady, but now this young man is having his educational opportunities ruined because he slightly resembles a perpetrator. And going from an innocent man to people who are definitely guilty, but were able to continue their crimes because of political correctness. About 1,400 Rotterdam children sexually exploited over a 16-year period. The uncompromising report on events in South Yorkshire town between 1997 and 2013 said in more than a third of these cases, the youngsters were already known to child protective agencies. The report said, by far the majority of the perpetrators were described as Asian by the victim. But the investigator said, counselors seemed to think it was a one-off problem they hoped would go away. And several staff described their nervousness about identifying the ethnic origins of the perpetrators for fear of being thought racist. Political correctness allowed these rapists to run wild in the Rotterdam streets. Now, let me be very clear. I'm not saying all Asians are rapists or Muslims or anything like that. It was these particular men who just so happened to be Asian, but they didn't want to come down on these guys. They didn't want to go round them up because of their ethnic origin. And these are the type of political correctness things we see in our societies and allow guilty people to get away with their crimes. You can find more reports at Infowars.com.
It is total mind control. It is total basket case brainwashing. To where she claims somebody raped her when she was in another state. This is what's taught on all the campuses, that the male act of sex with a female is inherently rape. That babies are parasites inside women. It's anti-human garbage to create some bizarre phobia where women's only identity is in hating men. When we all know the happiest women out there are with loving men and vice versa. And so many brainwashed feminists have been reformed and have actually found the love of a good man that serves them. They serve him. They have children. They become empowered. So many women have sent me letters and I've met them and they go, oh my God, I wish I'd have known this when I was younger. My parents just raised me that the state was God and that my identity was in hating men. And they have families with the last wave feminism where the man teaches them how fundamentally bad men are. We are the species. You don't say a male lion is bad. It is the species. Humanity isn't a man or a woman or a child, a boy or a girl. I mean, I love my daughters. And I want to put them in martial arts. We're planning to do that now that they've gotten old enough. 7 and 10, and my son has been in it, and I've been teaching him how to use the two older ones firearms. And I don't I mean it's just this, you are oppressing women, you are a white male, you are a, and then oh my gosh, you can't be in many areas of the campus, is basically kicked out of half the school because you slightly resemble. And then Jakari even qualifies by saying, we're very sorry if you got raped, lady, which I know he's being a gentleman. That's fine. But it just shows how we're like giving into these people. I would just laugh at him. This guy should sue them. Not just be, wow, my feelings are hurt. How dare them know he wasn't the rapist, but still investigate it. And then say, now stay out of this area of the school. Scientist specializing in the philosophy of law and constitutional theory. He's also a designer of high security residences and retreats. He's designed self-sufficient and high-security homes throughout North America and has consulted in Central America as well. He's the author of Strategic Relocation, North American Guide to Safe Places, that we sell both the film we produced and the book, big coffee table book, glossy pages, the best analysis out there at InfoWarsStore.com. He also assists people who live near a large city to develop contingency retreat plans. Joel was raised in Oregon, later served as a fighter pilot for the U.S. Marine Corps during Vietnam era, prior to being his design firm in high-security residences. During the 80s, he took leave of absence to serve as the chairman of the Conservative National Committee in Washington, D.C., and concurrently served as executive director, editor of Conservative Digest. JoelSkousen.com, WorldAffairsBrief.com. He's the editor of WorldAffairsBrief.com. And he joins us to cover news and the waterfront, and to take a few specific focused questions, not comments or diatribes, because we're limited on time today, from callers. That's coming up at about 45 after. 800-259-9231. 1-800-259-9231. Now, we never get into the social engineering with Joel Skousen and the attack on the family and Obama acting as a dictator, basically opening up the borders right now. All this unprecedented stuff. We need to talk about geopolitical and the price of oil and Ukraine and Russia and Greece. And we're going to hit all that first because he's an expert on that. But I want to cover the waterfront on a bunch of topics with Joel today to pick his brain. And Joel Skousen joins us via video Skype. If you're a radio listener, you can go to Infowars.com/show. And you can see Joel as well, or if you're a PrisonPlanet.tv subscriber, you can also see him there. But we have a free feed for the radio listeners during the daytime broadcast. But you can also subscribe and get the commercial-free podcast. We appreciate the subscribers out there that helped fund this for everybody else. But please take advantage of it. Send that link, Infowars.com/show, to your friends, to your family, at the end of your emails. You can wake folks up by just pushing our information in their direction, and that's how we grow via leaps and bounds. But as I said, going now to Joel Skousen, editor of World Affairs Brief, there's so much to cover, but I want to get into Russia, get into Ukraine, get into ISIS with you first, get into what's happening with the dollar, with oil, with Greece. Joel Skousen.
Well, thank you very much, Alex. It's really great to be with you. You know, we've had a lot of hype going on about the collapse of the euro, about nuclear war being imminent with Russia over Ukraine. And I continue to say, you know, there's a longer-term globalist agenda here that is not going to allow for these things to be imminent. And that's proving the dollar to collapse, the failure of the BRICS nation to be able to, you know, bring down the dollar, or what's going on in Greece right now, where we saw, as I predicted, the European Union gave in and gave them another four-month extension again. It wasn't 6 months that Greece wanted. The only concession that they gave was that Greece gets to pick their own austerity to by the Troika. And so that's a, you know, a small tactical diplomatic battle. They still have to come up with something today to tell how they're going to stop the continued tax evasion and reduction of civil service. But as I've said, you know, the longest agenda here is globalism, and the EU is it's the flower of globalism. It's the show place. They're not going to let that go down. And were to exit the Eurozone, it's not, I'm not convinced, in fact, I'm fully convinced that the EU wouldn't, even though other countries may want to follow suit. I think the euro is showing sign, or the EU is showing sign, of doing whatever it takes to keep Greek in, to keep the exit from handling, or from going on. And I think we'll continue to see that. Doesn't mean that things are solved. Greece has long-term problems. It's not going to be solved by this additional bailout, but it does kick the can down the road so that they can, there'll be other major crises that come.
Sure, but in the future, this global debt is all untenable. And you got Alan Greenspan saying something big's coming. You have all these other elites saying get ready for something big. Obviously, they engineer these things to consolidate power. Do you think it's going to be inflation? Do you think it's going to be deflation? Do you think the bubble's going to go on? And if so, for how long? Because most experts, John Williams, you name it, now say, Dr. Paul Craig Roberts has been saying 3-4 years, forever. Now he's saying it could be this year or next year that we see a global meltdown.
Yeah, I know They have been saying this, and they've been wrong for 3 and 4 years running. And it's because they haven't really looked at what does it take to destroy. Answered these things several times in the World Affairs Brief. I've never got a suitable response from Williams or Peter Schiff or Gerald Cellini on my major objections. Number one is that for hyperinflation, which is the major way to take the dollar, you've got to really have two things. You've got to have a very modest money supply that can be doubled or tripled in a year to depreciate and make it the dollar become worthless. But that isn't possible with the dollar. There's over 200 trillion monetized dollars, maybe even 300 trillion. And there's over 1,000 trillion non-monetized contractual dollars out there. The Fed could print over 20 trillion a year and not exceed 10% of the money supply. And that isn't hyperinflation. And then for hyperinflation to occur, the second thing has to occur. You got to have some kind of automatic indexing, automatic way for common people to raise their income to keep pace with inflation. Otherwise, you don't ever accumulate a full of $100 bills that are worthless because you don't have any way to get those excess dollars.
That's right. They have been expert at creating real depressions in the economy so that people never become wealthy enough to actually accumulate the excess dollars. That said, though, I do see real inflation in some of the goods and services out there, and I don't think if the economy wasn't contracting that they'd be able to stop inflation. I'm no economist. I just simply see them with their different computer models managing things, and I just wonder how long this can go on, Joel.
Yeah, I think actually can keep it going on a lot longer than we think. For example, the purpose of the zero debt policy is to keep the debt crisis from coming to a head. They can postpone that till after 2030 by keeping interest rates near zero, because that means that the interest on the debt does not accumulate faster. If they inflation, and John Williams is right, real inflation is between 6 and 7 to 8% now. If they can keep it that way, there won't be a hyperinflation. If they want to go, you start to have an inflation mentality where people want to get rid of their dollars, want to buy something, it would heat up the economy. But most people could not keep pace. That creates stagflation like we have in the 70s, where people can't afford to buy. They stop buying. If gas went to $10, people would stop buying again. And so the Fed shows every sign of, in fact, being very, very cautious to not let inflation get over. They've got the advantage also in that there's a great deal of deflationary forces going on right now in the economy, which is balancing out. I think inflation would probably be 12 to 14% if it weren't for the deflationary.
That's what I was just getting at, just from a layman's perspective. So, Joel Skousen, let me ask you this question. Geopolitically, how are things going for the Anglo-American power bloc versus the other blocs? Because we have numbers out, 4 out of 10 Americans are one bill from disaster, CBS News. I mean, in the real economy, we've been in a recession slash unequally distributed depression for a long time. But in certain corporate jobs or certain government jobs, people are still doing quite well. So it seems like they've created a new artificial class system.
That is exactly right. We have a selective recession right now. There's a lot of people with a lot of money. You look at the stock market, over 18,000 now. This is the money in the big speculative economy. These people get nearly free from the Fed that they can invest in these speculative economies and make 15 to 20%. Why should they invest in a lot of money being spread around the economy? The movie houses are full, the restaurants are full, and yet there's 20% real unemployment. But even that isn't like the Depression, where you had 25%. In the Depression, nobody had any reserves. There wasn't anything, you know, as in today's world, you've got food stamps, you've got unemployment compensation, you've got relatives to live with, people have 3 or 4 televisions, they've got 2 or 3 cars. There's a tremendous amount of reserves in this economy after 40, 50 years of inflation that is, in fact, making it more resistant to the dire things that happened in the
Depression. That's right. We've been such a wealthy nation that there's a lot of stores of wealth. People are living with their parents longer. But if you look at the demographic trends and if you look at the savings of younger people, I do see this coming to a cataclysmic collapse somewhere down the road. I mean, it can't go on forever.
That is correct, Alex. It can't go on forever. The key is, can the powers that be, can the Fed keep milking the bailouts along, and can they keep managing the money supply along until war comes? You see, then they escape the blame for this.
All right, Joel, your Skype's breaking up really bad all of a sudden. We're going to keep you on video Skype, but dial you on the telephone as we go to break here. We're going to come back with Joel Skousen. This is really important information he's talking about. What we have is a computerized, technocratic, organized economy. And as Google and all these systems get more and more into our lives, they're going to be able to game the system that much more. But in my view, the best laid plans of mice and men often go awry. And I see it only being a bigger implosion and spectacular crisis when it comes. Stay with us.
Attention Alex Jones listeners. When you're on the road or have limited data or Wi-Fi, now you can listen to Alex Jones unfiltered and untapped at no extra charge on this non-federal phone number, 1-605-562-5136. Try it now to listen to Alex Jones 24-7 at no extra cost or data charges. These are not on federal lines. These are lines located on Indian reservations off the grid. Call 1-605-562-5136. No smartphones or internet needed. To hear Alex Jones untapped and off the grid, just call 1-605-562-5136.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
As the New World Order continues to tighten its grip on every facet of our lives, we're all asking ourselves, how can we maintain our independence? The answer is clear. Get prepared and you get prepared now. Now the only question left is, where do we begin? My Patriot Supply is here to help. Call 800-247-3070 to get started with your 72-hour emergency food supply for only $10. We're even covering the cost of shipping. Are you willing to rely on the government and FEMA in the event of an emergency? Call 800-274-3070 to get started with your 72-hour emergency food supply for only $10. You won't be able to find this deal online, and there is a strict limit of 4 per caller, so don't wait. Call now, 800-274-3070. That's 800-274-3070. Call right now.
Used since before the days of the Roman Empire to support the body's natural systems and enhance overall health. Introducing the new InfoWarsLife.com oil of oregano formulation, a highly advanced nutraceutical form of this key herb that has been traditionally used by civilizations for thousands of years to promote health. We have now procured the most high quality and potent forms of oregano oil on the market, sourced from top leading manufacturers to ensure a concentrated level of bioactive ingredients. Extracted directly from the wild herb and sealed in easy-to-use capsules, you will no longer need to endure the burning of liquid oregano on the tongue. Wild-crafted from the Mediterranean oregano species that experts agree is one of the most powerful and most challenging to acquire. This winter season, it's more important than ever to secure this true form of oil of oregano. Now available in our limited first run at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139.
Are you hungry for delicious, nutritious, rich, and satisfying home-cooked meals? Discover the Vita Clay 4-in-1 Smart Organic Cooker. Unglazed Zeesha Clay, an ancient secret that makes this fast multi-cooker so special. Infusing your food with incredible flavors, perfect texture, vitamins, and minerals for your good health. It's a slow cooker, rice cooker, a steamer, plus a yogurt maker. Go to VitaClayChef.com and enter promo code RADIO20 for 20% off at checkout. That's VitaClayChef.com.
Hear that? That's the sound of a house being trashed while a gang of thieves ransack the place. And what they don't steal will be destroyed.
This year, resolve not to be the next victim of a break-in. Go to faketv.com and discover a device that creates the illusion someone inside is watching TV, even when you're miles away. Security is a mindset, and fake TV should be part of your security solution. Be vigilant, but not fearful. faketv.com.
Jones here back live. Joel Skousen of World Affairs Brief is our guest, the editor of World Affairs Brief. Your phone calls are lining up. Brandon, Judy, Ben, Wayne, and others. I want to talk about the moral decline, why the establishment has engineered it, and where this country is in the future. And the huge preparations for civil oppression we see going on. We'll do that in the next segment. But getting into Russia, getting into the Middle East, the ISIS threat, clearly created and given a safe harbor by the West, the different power vacuums that are being battled over by Iran, by Saudi Arabia. Are we really at war with ISIS? Is it blowback? Has it gotten out of control? Or is there something bigger? I want to get Joel Skousen's take on that. Joel?
Well, thanks, Alex. ISIS is, as you said, a Western intelligence-engineered crisis. Essentially, al-Qaeda was becoming old hat. Everyone was claiming to be al-Qaeda, and nothing was ever happening domestically to cross the border. I've questioned that for years. If we had real terrorism and we got a wide-open border with Mexico, what's keeping al-Qaeda from coming across the border daily and blowing up electrical pylons or blowing themselves up in malls? And what's keeping ISIS from coming over to do that? It's just unexplainable, except for the fact that these intelligent these terrorist organizations at the top, at least, are controlled by the governments, and they are not giving orders to do so. And the reason is that it would get in the way of the social agenda of engineering a Democratic majority through millions of Latinos crossing the border. If we had terrorism coming across the border, the Americans would demand that shut that border down immediately. And that's why they're not allowing terrorism to come across. They control to the top. They don't control necessarily. In other words, the normal terrorist doesn't know that the top leadership's controlled by the U.S. intelligence, British intelligence, working through Israeli Mossad agents, Arab agents trained by Israel. But that's really the reality, what we're doing here. And all of these ISIS videos are staged. I mean, this latest one was just a joke with the 20 so-called Christians beheaded. You see these ISIS characters in black almost towering a third the height over these Christian.
That's right. We've looked at it. It's blue screen. Even Wired Magazine 6-7 years ago had to come out and admit their video analysts looked at the NQTEL videos they were releasing of Adam Gadon, the son of the head of the ADL, who's supposedly the leader of al-Qaeda now, a Jewish al-Qaeda member. And the al-Qaeda video was put out in the Pentagon video layer with their logo. It was the same produced video at the same time.
Yeah, these are professionally produced videos by Western video experts. Terrorists don't have these kinds of capabilities to do this. Really, the reason for creating ISIS was, as I think I've explained before on your show, very carefully, Israel has been tasked by the globalists ever since 2004 to attack Iran. They've said, we can't do it until you take down Syria. 2 years ago, they were set to take down Syria with that no-fly zone. That's when Kerry made the mistake in the London press conference when a reporter asked him, is there anything that Syria can do to evade this? He said, well, sure, they could give up their chemical weapons. And wham, Syria and Russia said, we accept. And all of a sudden, in one mistake, Kerry derailed the entire rationale for going into Syria. So that's when they began to create ISIS in order to justify a backdoor approach to getting into Syria. We create a new terrorist organization. Basically, they divided the rebels in Syria into two groups. Say, you're going to be the existing rebels, and you're going to be the new group called ISIS, and we'll set you off into Iraq. But you come from Syria, so we'll have an excuse to get back into Syria to attack ISIS.
And now they're announcing all of that, and we talked about this last year and predicted it. It's now happening. It also throws the military off the rank and file, who were really getting upset 2 years ago about openly backing al-Qaeda. Now they have a reason to go back in the region. Oh, and while we're at it, call in airstrikes for the good Syrian rebels. So exactly as we said they would do it, they're now doing it.
That's right. They've got Turkey involved in direct shipping of arms and ammunition and funds and things to both sides, ISIS and the so-called moderate rebels. They're all controlled by Western intelligence through Israeli agents who are peppered the area with very highly trained Arab Muslim radicals that they've trained to go in and direct these things and to be the recipients of various funds. So this is a very directed false flag attack of ISIS. But it is still meant to keep Americans diverted from the real crisis in the future, which is Russia and China, as they continue to build for a strike against the West. I do not believe that Ukraine is going to trigger that directly. I think this is a 3 or 4 year process.
All right, stay there. We got to go to break. Yeah. Long segment coming up. We'll segue into the detonator for World War III. Is it Ukraine? Is it North Korea? What's really happening in Ukraine? Joel Skousen's expert opinion. He knows what he's talking about, folks. We'll be right back and take your phone calls. I'm Alex Jones.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we, the Patriots, hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
Used since before the days of the Roman Empire to support the body's natural systems and enhance overall health. Introducing the new InfoWarsLife.com oil of oregano formulation, a highly advanced nutraceutical form of this key herb that has been traditionally used by civilizations for thousands of years to promote health. We have now procured the most high quality and potent forms of oregano oil on the market, sourced from top leading manufacturers to ensure a concentrated level of bioactive ingredients. Extracted directly from the wild herb and sealed in easy-to-use capsules, you will no longer need to endure the burning of liquid oregano on the tongue. Wild-crafted from the Mediterranean oregano species that experts agree is one of the most powerful and most challenging to acquire. This winter season, it's more important than ever to secure this true form of oil of oregano. Now available in our limited first run at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Want to just say, great job last week for three of the days or so that David Knight sat in broadcasting. I want to thank him for the wonderful job he did. Joel Skousen is our guest, worldaffairsbrief.com. And your calls are coming up here in just a few minutes. Specific questions for Joel Skousen, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Joel, I want to finish up with Russia and China and geopolitical issues and just get your take on the eugenics, anti-human, anti-family, anti-male, political correctness people say, oh, silly political correctness, but it's really designed to do something more, curtail language and just shut people down and teach a form of ninnying knowledge, of obsessing on what people say and being offended to shut down real debate. But before we go there, finishing up with Russia and what you think is happening in Ukraine.
Well, we are seeing, as I continue to predict, that Russia is being let have a pass here. They are in really open invasion now within Ukraine with limited troops, but highly trained troops. Ukraine is actually sabotaging their own version of the war. The generals have leaked out. They're not allowed to win this. They're not allowed to put in sufficient troops to win anything. It's a phony war. But, you know, we continue to battle the major propaganda within our own movement, Alex, of those, and these are sincere people, most of them. I mean, the Eric Zusses and the Lenmans are pro-Russian leftists who will continue to claim that Russia has no sins, that Putin has no sins, that Castro has no sins. This is just a globalist conspiracy against these innocent countries. But it is not. The globalists are not innocent. They want to provoke war, but they really don't want to, in fact, engage Russia. They want Russia to continue to look worse as they move through, and Russia is a predator nation. Russia is in Ukraine to take back Ukraine before World War III, and you'll see that after Ukraine is taken, at least half of Ukraine, they probably won't get through completely to Western Ukraine, but I think they'll get it surrounded with Moldova. Fully half of Ukraine will fall to the new Russia, and then they'll start working on the Baltics. All the while, I'll tell you, NATO will do nothing, and the U.S. will do nothing. Sending arms to Ukraine will do nothing because there's no way that they can be used, sophisticated arms, without training. It'll be, if anything, a giveaway to the Russians who will capture a lot of those weapons. And I continue to insist, though, that the anti-globalists, of which I count myself as one, certain of our members on it are incorrect when they continue to hype that this was a Western promulgated coup. It's true that the Western governments went there facilitating some of the opposition, but this was, in fact, a Russian coup to the core. A year ago, almost this week, we saw the unexplainable happen, where the opposition was allowed to win because the riot police, run by the pro-Russian Yanukovych regime, were ordered back to the barracks, giving the opposition the free run of the governmental palace, the governmental buildings. And then on the Saturday following that day, the pro-Russian Party of Regions ousted their own president. It would be as if constitutional conservatives had been rioting and protesting in Washington, D.C. for 3 months, and all of a sudden the Marines abandoned the White House, let us walk through the White House, and the next day the Democrats ousted Barack Obama. How believable would that be? But that's exactly what happened in Ukraine. It could not have been a Western coup because the Western opposition had no powers to order the bear coup back to the barracks and to order the Republic or the their version of the Democratic Party to oust their own leader. And that's why I say this is a false Western, pro-Western government, particularly sabotaging the war, working in combination with Russia to eventually let Russia take back Ukraine.
Now, Joel Skousen, I agree with you on probably 97% of what you have to say. And on this subject, I get your perspective. What you're saying is true. But let's pull back. When this all started a year ago, I went and showed the clips of the State Department saying we've put $5 billion in the last 15 years. George Soros made statements on CNN on different shows that he was involved in the destabilization. They want to destabilize, have the two sides fight with each other, let Russia carve off a piece of it in probably some secret deal. Then the EU can come in and say, we've got to resurrect this and bail out the EU with Federal Reserve money, claiming that it's not an EU bailout, but that it's a Marshall Plan. Well, we just saw tens of billions already sent in. They're calling it a Marshall Plan. So it's a larger destabilization of the whole region to then launch the new Cold War for the new buildup for the next phase. And this is more like Hitler and Stalin dividing Poland before official World War II broke out and Hitler double-crossed Stalin in Operation Barbarossa. So that's what I see happening. So I don't lionize the West or the Putonians, I guess you could call them. But clearly that area of Ukraine has pretty much always been part of Russia. This is a replay of World War II with Eastern Russian Ukraine battling Western European Ukraine. And so that's why you see the same players there. So I see it more as the globalists just wanting turmoil to consolidate control.
Well, you got to remember, the globalists are playing both sides, always have. They've been building up Russia while they pretend to fight Russia in a Cold War, building up China while they pretend to fight. Same thing happening here. It was a propaganda lie when Victoria Nuland said that they'd put $5 billion into Ukraine. That was the entire budget for all of Eastern Europe. You can't put $5 billion into a country like Ukraine and not have it show up in the banking system. In other words, she was propagandizing, speaking to a pro-Ukrainian rally. But there's no way that they injected that directly into Ukraine. And George Soros, being a globalist leader, is basically feeding the fire within Russia and others to give people who want to believe this was a Western coup. But you see, the U.S. knows, the media knows that the coup went back to the barracks. The media knows the Party of Regions unelected their own leader. Nobody in the press has asked why and how did that happen and how did the Western opposition do that. Until someone answers that question, my proof stands. This was a ruse, just like the phony fall of the Soviet Union was a deception. The phony coup in Ukraine is a Russian coup, and that Poroshenko and Yushchenko are working for the Russians and sabotaging. That's why Poroshenko has all his friends are Russian oligarchs. That's why he betrayed the Eastern Russians after with his campaign promises. He refused to let them speak Russian in Eastern Ukraine. He enraged them. He sent in mercenaries to attack his own people, to betray.
So that Russia could then look like the savior coming in and taking over.
Yeah, in other words, they've been sabotaging. This looks like, I've got the proof, as I say, that these pro-Western leaders are actually still working for Russia, just like Tymoshenko was working for Putin.
Well, I mean, it's on record that the entire leadership of Al-Qaeda and ISIS is working for NATO, working for the U.S., working for Turkey, working for Israel, working for Pakistan. I mean, it just keeps coming out. So that would fit the paradigm.
That's right. We have to look deeper than the obvious on these things. And going back to this, I still think that the trigger for World War III is not going to be Ukraine. It's going to build up Russia as the hegemonious enemy right across the border from Europe, and it's going to allow Europe to... But I think we're going to see just like happened in Yalta, just like what happened in Munich, we're going to see them continue to pamper and be permissive with the Russians right up into the war. But the actual trigger probably started North Korea. Has to be a reason why the Western governments continue to be pervasive with North Korea compared to Iran. There's going to be a war in the Middle East with Iran as soon as Syria is taken down with Israel attacking Iran. But ultimately, I think we have time. I think this war is going to cover for the excuse of getting the entire West into a militarized global government. And I think that's where all this is leading. But I don't think it's imminent. I think this is going to take time. You're going to see Ukraine mature for another year before they move into the Baltics. And the reason I say that is that Russia and China still need more time to continue to build these weapon systems that they're in the process of building right now. And we are going to continue to disarm, which is suicidal.
But as you said, that's to entice the attack when the whole secret project... Just like
that's
NASA's
right.
80% secret, the military, what we see of the military is not really the main military. What we see is more of our UN occupation force military that's 30 years old.
That's right. Our government has secret weapon systems they're developing. They're going to allow this nuclear attack on American military forces so as to justify getting us into a new world order. They need our American military forces to be taken down in order to rampage or get us into a militarized global government. But then they're going to pull out, I think, these secret weapons, probably space-based anti-missile weapons that are really effective with warheads on them, unlike our current crop of ABMs. And they're going to hold back the Russian and Chinese nuclear attacks while they regroup. And I think there's going to be a...
But the Russians and Chinese are smart. They know about all the secret weapons.
I'm not sure they do. I think they suspect. That's what's kept them at bay for many. That's why they're still skittish about attacking. But I don't.
I mean, didn't they see how we set up Japan to attack? I mean, they got to know that's how the West and the British intelligence operates.
Yeah, you know, you would think so. But you've got to remember that the Russians and the Chinese have as part of their strategic blood, they must attack the West. They do want to take down the West, so they're not going to be deterred. They're just looking for how much more can we build before we're confident enough to take them down. And I think, you know, with PDD-60, which they also have got to know about, PDD-60 tells our nuclear forces not to expect to launch on warning, but to expect to absorb a nuclear first strike. That was 1997. I think that was a telegraph message. Don't expect to get the codes to be able to launch against the first strike. You're going to absorb a first strike.
Yeah, and they took the launch codes away from the sub-commanders, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And then they, you know, had that agreement with Clinton, with the Soviets. It was just a one-sided agreement. We're going to keep 50% of our missile submarines in port at any one time to make sure that you can target it more easily, to show our good intent that we have no offensive attempt.
But as you know, there's a lot of hidden secret nukes that the United States has. I mean, everybody cheats.
I'm convinced that the globalists have a plan to win this after they absorb a nuclear first strike on our military. But remember, the cities are not the target. The Russians and Chinese want to blackmail us into submission, not destroy the markets that they depend on. So I think the globalists know that. This is a very complex scenario, I understand. People's reluctance to want to maybe see this.
Well, it's kind of a paradox. They need our military to be kind of the UN global force. They want to build up NATO as the new UN army. That's admitted. That's who they keep using for these UN operations. But they know inherently one of the only cores of Americana, even though our military has been part of these evil wars, is the military. They know the military is the most awake group of the globalist conspiracy. That's why they want to coup d'etat them in a nuclear attack.
Yeah, I think you're right, Alex.
Well, that fits in because they absolutely hate the military. Look what they do to them with these secret death lists and all the rest of it. We didn't get to get into social issues. I want to have you back soon to do that because I want to go to phone calls, as promised. Brandon in Texas, you're on the air with Joel Skousen. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. First and foremost, God bless both of you guys. I'm a huge fan. My question is, whether it's a global war or some kind of economic collapse, we hear a lot about collecting gold and silver coins, so on and so forth, for use for barter, but how would that really be any use to another person that's, you know, up a creek just like me or anybody else in that event? Wouldn't it be more useful in that case to stockpile things that people will need, like something that's made out of unobtainium, like 22 ammo nowadays, I'm sure you guys noticed, and maybe even just for comfort, like something along the lines of cigarettes. I don't smoke them, but maybe I should buy some, or little bottles of whiskey. What do you think about that?
Well, I think precisely that stockpiling things that remove your future need for money and provide barter items is really your best option. But remember, too, that cash will be king. I predict that there will not be hyperinflation before this war comes. They're going to continue to try to keep things down below 10%. Thus, you can hoard some cash. But believe me, there won't be any cash printing when war starts. And so cash will be king until it starts to run out, and then prices rise because of shortages. That's when gold and silver become more valuable, when prices rise, because right now you wouldn't be able to get change for a $2,000 gold coin. I like silver dollars as the premier barter coin, just because they're big and fat and heavy, and they're legal tender. People don't have to determine whether or not this is a real coin or not. I think if you're going to stockpile anything, silver dollars is going to be the best one, rather than quarters and dimes that are silver, because they look too much like what's out there existing. So silver dollars, cash will be king first of all, then silver dollars. But ultimately, in the long term of this war, and there's going to be starvation, there's going to be famine for a couple of years, got to be able to get out of those urban areas, and you're going to have stockpiles to use and to trade, especially things that are usable, like light bulbs, like glues, screws, ammunition, those
shortwave radios, and let's just say it, Joel, you know, people will do anything for liquor once this all goes down. People could argue it'd be immoral, but the classic barter item would also be like things like whiskey.
Well, you know, the so-called, the Bosnian guy who's promoting his wares about survival is talking about, you know, cigarette lighters were key. Well, they aren't here in the United States. In Europe, people still smoke like chimneys, but not here. So it's not going to, smoking is not going to be a barter item like it is in Europe. Liquor may be, but I still think a lot of Americans will need food and things to repair things quicker than they'll need liquor.
I was about to say, somebody that's got their own solar power and wind power and like a tinker repair machine shops, those will end up being little mini cities during a full collapse, right?
That's right. You know, and the Bosnian guy claims, well, nobody used any cars, but that was Bosnia. Those were high-density urban areas. Out here in the West and things, fuel will be king as well, and you will be able to sell fuel like gold someday. So there's a lot of things that you can stockpile that are, I think, more useful ultimately than gold and silver.
Oh, absolutely. Fuel out in areas that aren't dense will be king. Brandon, does that answer your question?
Pretty much. I have maybe a little bit of a continuation of that question. Mr. Skousen mentioned that people should be getting out of urban areas. But wouldn't those be the most likely areas that the powers that be at the time would want to control? And as we've seen in places like Somalia and others, that those are the places where they delivered the food supplies, where the rural areas were pretty much left to their own devices.
Well, that's right, and that's why you want to be in the rural areas so that they leave you alone, basically, and have your stockpiles. Remember, you can't grow in urban areas. You are totally dependent on
people. We've got to go to break. Stay there. We'll be right back.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
The month of February is all about Valentine's Day. Big heart-shaped boxes filled with delicious candy. What if we the Patriots hijacked Valentine's Day and instead made it about human liberty and individual empowerment? I'm all about human potential. I'm all about the individual being empowered. The establishment is the opposite. That's why they spike our water with fluoride, GMO, estrogen mimickers, and the rest of the garbage. InfoWars is striking back in the month of February with Human Empowerment Month. How we can come together and win the human race. And to celebrate the kickoff of Human Empowerment Month, we're slashing prices on InfoWarsLife.com products like Super Male and Super Female Vitality. The sale is only running for the month, 20% off, and there's a lot of other powerful specials at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com, celebrating human potential in the month of February. Visit InfoWarsLife.com to find this special and many others in the month of February. Again, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
This is an alert. If your business or church is building this year, you're about to pay more than you should. This could mean thousands of dollars more for your office, retail space, church, or warehouse. A General Steel building can save you as much as half the cost and time of similar conventional construction. And we're offering rebates of up to $20,000 to help you build today. Call General Steel for free information that could save you thousands. Call 866-91-STEEL. 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Joel Skousen is our guest. Medical supplies will be king during a collapse, but of course the public doesn't have general access to those now, plus they don't have a good shelf life. The elite are buying redoubts. We talked about this 15 years ago, but it was even the London Guardian last week or 2 weeks ago that elites are buying places all over the world in rural areas and putting in long airstrips so they can run from Europe and the U.S. Most of the rich billionaires in Israel have left Israel the last 5 years. And we talked about this before it was known because we have a lot of sources. I know Joel does and I do as well, but he builds houses for, you know, really rich folks and common folks as well that are secure. So they've been running to the hills. They're not running into the cities. Those are the places you won't want to be during a collapse. You want to elaborate on that, Joel, before we go to Judy?
Yeah, even the cities will not be able to be controlled by the powers that be. I mean, there's just, I mean, I don't even think policemen are going to show up for duty. Soldiers aren't going to show up for duty because their families will be subject to mobs. It's just going to be chaos. So people will leave the cities. It's a matter of preparing places before that happens so that you're not caught in the maelstrom.
And know your neighbors. So if a group, you know, 2 years into a collapse comes over there, it'll be just like Road Warrior wanting to take over. You're ready to deal with them. The good part about areas that have the Second Amendment, though, I predict those are going to be areas that are a lot safer. What about areas where they've disarmed people like California and D.C., you know, that have cultures of just supine worshiping of tyranny? My God, those are going to be carnal, charnel houses of hellish exploits by the criminal element.
Absolutely. That's why in strategic relocation, you know, we rate different areas differently, especially by these criteria like Second Amendment, like the freedom to homeschool, freedom for natural medical care, as well as climate and other things. A lot of good information in strategic relocation that people ought to
get. People should get the book and the film at InfoWarsStore.com. I mean, if people don't, I think they're insane. Both of them are so well done, and we're honored to work with you on that. That's what the whole illegal alien open invasion's about. I mean, Obama is acting as a dictator, but notice the Republicans aren't challenging him, Joel.
No, that's right. And there was a judge that had the guts to shut it down, and now the Obama administration is shopping for a judge to release that that order so that the illegal agenda can keep going forward. But I think that's why the southern states have got a problem. You know, Texas, even where you are, you know, it's going to be a Mexican state one of these days, again, I think.
Well, that's the globalist plan, to get folks to vote with the Democratic agenda. That's the plan.
That's right. They want to water down conservative voting patterns, and they're not going to stop this illegal flow no matter what we do. It's one of those things, they don't take no for an answer.
Judy in Florida. Judy, you're on the air. Welcome.
Yes. Hi, Alex.
Hi.
In listening, I'm just really getting more and more concerned and frightened, really, about what is coming over our border, whether it's the illegal aliens or the Chinese that are coming here and having children. But all that aside,
well, it's because America's been totally sold out. I mean, we offer to pay for anybody's kids in the world, and this is the plan to turn us into a Tower of Babel. Go ahead.
Yeah, and I know people that are perfectly fine with that I thought were real intellectuals and people that I thought loved this country, but they're just brainwashed, crazy people. But what I don't understand is how this is not really like a currency war that's taking place, and I guess this is my question, is how is this not really a currency war? Because isn't the Anglo-American establishment just looking for the boogeyman that they can blame when the financial collapse does occur? I mean, they want World War III, don't they, in full swing? And also, what do you say to the people like me and my family that are not going to be able to get to some type of armored redoubt, and we're going to be stuck in mainland America, you know, with all the suffering?
That's a good point. Joel?
Well, as I say, you know, the currency wars are continue to go back and forth, but I'm going to tell you, the dollar will remain king. There's no other currency in the world that can replace the dollar. The euro would have to be inflated.
Stay there. We're going to come back and finish up with that and Overdrive and go to Truth. Ben, Gregory, Aaron, and others, stay with us. Joel Skousen is our guest.
Genesis Communications Radio Network.
What disaster is so powerful? It unleashes a chain of mass pandemics, economic meltdowns, and violent food riots, all at the same time. NASA has already set the countdown timer, and right now the 21st century apocalypse is less than 13 months away. Former CIA Director James Woolsey says two-thirds of U.S. population could perish. In a matter of seconds, the world as we know it will cease to exist. The world's economy will be wiped out. Mass riots will follow. Ancient diseases will reemerge. How will you shield yourself and your loved ones from this upcoming apocalypse? Go to darkestdays.info to find out proven methods of protecting yourself, your loved ones, and even your entire community when this worst-case scenario unravels. That's darkestdays.info. Darkestdays.info. Go there before this life-saving information becomes unavailable to the large public. Go to darkestdays.info now.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
All right, fixed bayonets. We're in overdrive. Jamming a few final calls here.
Fix bayonets.
I'm your host, Alex Jones. Let's go to who's been holding the longest here. Let's go to Ben in Missouri. You're on the air, Ben. Welcome.
Hey, great to talk to you again, Alex. Your guest, as always, is really informative. I wanted to say as well, I got another bottle of Super Male Vitality in the mail this past week after not having it for a few weeks. And, you know, it's not like there was a problem before, but now there's not a problem, and then there's not a problem, and then there's not a problem. So that's,
well, and again, it's not a drug. It's not herbs that hype you up or anything. It's just herbs that get your glands naturally going. All of our glands have been suppressed by the additives and all the garbage. The testosterone of a 50-year-old man is half of what it should be on average. Growth hormones are a lot lower than it should be. And it's just a fact that God's given us natural things of the earth that aren't drugs that have great results. So thank you. Super Male and Super Female Vitality are amazing. Thanks for the plug.
Yeah, well, anyway, like I was going to say, I actually live in a densely populated urban area. I'm in St. Louis City, in one of the safer areas of St. Louis City. My question for your guest is, what are the most important things to get before you need to bug out? So if the worst-case scenario happens, and, you know, obviously you make your preparations as you can, but say you only have enough, you know, a truck bed to fill up, what are the things that he would recommend?
I think the most important thing, just to interrupt here, is to pick the right place you're going to go. And then to answer the other lady's question first, what do you do if you don't have money to get out of a major city, Joel?
Well, I agree with you, Alex. It's not a matter of what you can carry with you out, because you may have to walk out. That's why you've got to pick a place and have things stockpiled in advance, or even if it's at a friend's house that's 30 miles out of the city. You want to stockpile fuel. You want to stockpile other things so that if you can get out, you know, and some people, you know, you can get cars, old cars, dime a dozen, stockpiled at a friend's place so that even if you have to walk away, then you can drive once you're out of the areas. But the key is get your stockpiles distributed out so that they're not stuck in the city when you try to leave.
All right, caller, I'm going to jump. Thank you so much for the kind words. We got 20% off on the Super Male and Female Vitality products. If you'll just try them, we could fund our whole operation. If you try them, almost everybody that buys keeps buying. So in the equation, we get enough people to buy it, we're going to be able to really expand this operation because it's that good. InfoWarsLife.com. Let's now go to Gregory in Illinois. You're on the air with Joel Skousen. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi, Alex. Hi, Joel.
Hi.
My question, I don't know, Joel, if you were the guest of Alex that predicted that the Ebola outbreak was a stimulant, an Ebola stimulant.
No, he's the one that said that. He thought it was a stimulant and not really Ebola. And they were just using it as a pretext to learn how to take over in an emergency, which Obama later basically admitted. So they were dragging people away, but it was all just to see what we'd do. Basically, Joel?
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't intended to become the major plague. They were trying to invent other strains that are more suitable for biological warfare, but they were prepping the areas, and we said the measles thing right now is prepping people for mandatory vaccines.
So it's just all PR brainwashing events, because the doctors were seeing people disappeared. We had them on the show, but who knows what was going on? I mean, we just know there was a cover-up. Anything else, Gregory?
Yeah, what I was wondering, if it really was a stimulant, because that kind of, like, the story just kind of disappeared, and I thought maybe the virus or whatever it was mutated faster than they thought it would.
Well, they aren't telling us whether or not able to harvest mutated forms. I'm sure they were trying. They were taking blood samples over everything. But it is dying now. The virus is dying out. Most of those areas covered.
And praise God for that. The scary thing is that AP reported in New Jersey they have a secret Ebola center that locals weren't told about. So we know they use it as a pretext to test medical tyranny disappearing people, just like with measles and the four shots. WorldAffairsBrief.com. That's Joel Skousen's site. Get his book and film at InfoWarsStore.com and support the broadcast. Thank you, Joel.
Thank you, Alex.
Healthy elimination is essential to high energy, a cheerful mood, and prevention of disease. Some of the founders of our modern holistic health thinking state that disease begins in
OptiFactors and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds. BioPK.